That's right, ladies and gentlemen. It's time for another unnerving session of ghost stories. I called Cyril before the stream. We decided to wear semi-matching clothes. And of course, none of our hair is matching because of Suresh Menon.
How are
you? Sir Menon, your hair is extreme, Kulisha. Extremely beautiful.
Cyril Dabrilo. I have to press the button again.
Thank you. And my fellow t-shirt doppelganger, Hoezaay Kawako.
I feel like someone is missing here, but yeah. I don't know who.
Yeah, there's normally like a
anyway,
box.
Anyway, chalo shuru. Yeah. I think shuru karte hai na.
Karte hai. Karte
hai. But I received a message also. Sahu, wherever you are, jaldi aaja bhai.
I ran a poll before we started this saying, will Cyrus say unnerving tonight? 1,441 votes, and most people have other options were yes, yes, and maybe. Most people have gone with yes, some have gone with maybe. So let's
I
see
said
how
maybe.
That goes.
That's what
I'm just gonna close that poll. Anyway, yeah. Just please interrupt only when I start a sentence. Sir. Ready? Let's try that again. So, ladies, good. We're working on our timing. That's getting better. Good evening, everyone. Welcome to the Ghost Story stream. You know the deal. You know what you have to do. You have to go hit like. But more importantly, go to the description. Find Chinmay's Instagram account and thank him for that amazing thumbnail artwork. The artwork just keeps getting better and better. People are posting this in our Discord server and I've been going in line. So if you've posted before, we're going in line slowly. Go to my channel, you'll find top right, you'll find a Discord link, join the Discord server so you can come and post your stuff over there. Suresh Menon's hair is already very scared. We don't know what's going to... Last time's stream was really creepy, guys. I don't know.
Oh, I have a few incidents to report.
Do you?
Incidents?
Yeah.
From LinkedIn or what are you talking about?
No, no, from real life. So I've actually been trying to reach out to the other world. And spirits, so I've been talking to a few of them.
You mean Netherlands or like otherworld? Matlab?
Otherworld matlab,
I can see Sahu's online right now on WhatsApp. So he must be starting his computer and his phone or something. Yeah. You know, he puts his phone off after every phone call.
Yeah. That's good. Yeah. I think he holds the button down too long by mistake. That's why.
Anyway, we're about to start. We're going to jump straight into it. If anybody knows where Cyrus is, we'll pull him in. Cyrus, you send us a message or call us or something or just scream outside at the window. We will let you in. Cyril, what are you eating? Some people want to know. Hello, Harami chat. Good to have you here. 1,000 habubus to you all.
And,
Cyril,
look, and 15 puchuks from me.
Puchuks,
15 puchuks. Lovely.
Well, yeah. Well, I'm going with the typical diet for ghost stories, which is a touch of toast with a nice cup of tea. You know, I think it goes very well with it. Yeah.
See, you use that for love advice also. Very strange.
I do because that's also just as scary. Yeah, but anyway.
Anyway, for people who are missing Habubu, he will Habibi here very soon.
Yeah. I also want to take this opportunity, Hoezaay, interrupt you. To also basically say that I want to discuss exercises because a lot of people have been DMing. Okay, one person basically DM saying that they get very scared after they watch the stream and now they can't sleep. So I'm going to give you a couple of exercises to get past this fear. You know, it kind of worked for me. So we'll discuss it down the stream, you know, as we progress.
Cyrus is calling me. Should I take it? What if he says something strange? Okay. Cyrus, everyone can hear you. You're live on the stream.
Hello, my brother. I just got home from work. So I'll be logging in now.
Okay, come, aaram se. Come, we're waiting for you, okay? When he says just got home from work, he's been like moving people's potted plants around in the building.
I saw him running on the road there just a few minutes ago. So I don't know what work he's
doing. Okay, let's lay down the ground rules. Like I said, go to the description, send all those people some love. Don't forget to hit like on the stream. Also, if you've already been on the stream and you've told us a ghost story, please don't take up somebody else's slot. They throw a handkerchief on the seat and they keep it there. So, you know, you can't do that to them. It's not fair. So let's go. Suresh, all good? You look like you're checking.
Just checking somebody.
Are you watching Instagram Germany versus Portugal? Who's going to be giving us Germany versus Portugal scores?
Please get the match started.
I'm not into that.
I think I'll start watching.
So somebody suggested that you can have the football match on mute. and you can have this story in your ears, whatever floats your boat.
All right.
If we can do a match one day like that, football matches, it's actually, it won't be as long as our podcast.
Bro, you know, by the time this stream is over, na, ghar pe sab log so jaate hai, the whole place is silent and it gets very creepy.
No, somebody has messaged me. I'll have to check my LinkedIn also. Right now, Nitesh Ratnani messaged and he said that Suresh, in capital, all caps, my dad has a story for you all. As if he's screaming at me. Okay, Nitesh.
I don't think he's screaming.
We'll try to bring him in.
Suresh, I think his cap lock must be stuck.
Some people are dual screening. Like Vishal. Okay, Ayush, you need to put your microphone on.
Ayush.
And jump in and unnerve us. Guys, man. I'll do Sahi the Cyrus hai? Stuff till Sahu comes. He ran away, yeah. This guy.
Oh, you really scared him away.
Yeah. At all, not to worry at all.
Suresh, you know, wo mat khale na.
I've got a great horror voice.
Yeah.
Tell me what you'll think of it.
Yeah.
Hello. Good evening.
That's a horror voice.
Yeah, it's my new horror voice.
That is Harold's voice.
We're slowly warming up, getting to the scene.
Hello. Good evening.
Hey, so strange coincidence. Today I got an offer for featuring in a horror film. Of course, I have not yet said yes to them. Because
wow. Still good stuff, Suresh.
Yeah.
Wow.
What are you planning on doing?
I'm playing the ghost.
Really? No, you're just screwing with us.
This is like invisible.
Anyway, real quick, some super chats over here. We've got Tanu Channels eagerly waiting for Cyril Baba's post ghost story exercise. Pradeep says, why all the Kanmasti videos changed to private? If you ask me again, I'll answer. No. So they've changed to private because we're re-editing and re-uploading and making them 2021 sort of like friendly. So please go over to come to our Discord server. Come. Ajo. Udhar dekho. Sab pinned message dekh lena. Sab tumko information mil jayega. Akhil, are you there?
Jonas message chhod raha
hai. Sab log bhoot ban ke apne ko blank calls de rahe.
People from the other side are trying to reach out, but they don't have great network.
Yeah, I think these are people from the other side. Akhil.
Guys, Calvin sleeping.
Ah, yeah. Calvin is connecting.
Don't talk loudly.
Oh,
Calvin, tera D. Are?
Hi, Calvin.
2021 sort of like friendly.
Stream, but
yeah.
Are he's very happy.
You sound too happy for a ghost story.
You have to change the vibe. You have to change the vibe slightly. You can't be like,
get into character, Calvin. Get into character.
It's really awesome, guys. I really wanted to get into the stream. I've been following you guys since the Kaan Masti days. And main har bar room mein wait kiya. Matlab mere ko ek bar to aane ka hai room mein. Mere ko aane ka hai. मैं लव ये भी फॉलो कर रहा है ठीक है अभी पनवेल का ट्रेन आने के पहले मैं अपना घोस्ट स्टोरी बोलता हूं ठीक है
वाह ठीक है परे मोरे
सो आई वाज बैक इन कॉलेज ओके एंड आई यूज्ड टू लिसन टू अ लॉट ऑफ हेवी मेटल बैक देन व्हिच आई डू नाउ एज़ वेल एंड एवरी टाइम सो आई लिव्ड इन अ 1 बीएचके विद टू एल्डर सिस्टर्स लाइक पूरा मतलब बॉम्बे का लाइफस्टाइल जैसे जिया मैं ठीक है तो पूरा घर भरा हुआ है मतलब मैं फिर जाता था अलग से रूम में हेवी मेटल सुनने के लिए एंड ऑल दैट सो एवरी नाइट आई वुड लिसन टू अ लॉट ऑफ हेवी मेटल एंड स्टफ लाइक दैट सो इन बिटवीन एमिनेम्स एल्बम आल्सो लॉन्च्ड एंड आई वाज लाइक ये भी सही है ये भी सुनेगा मैं सो ऑल दैट स्टफ वाज हैपनिंग एंड वन नाइट जस्ट लाइक यूजुअली वी फिनिश्ड डिनर एंड ऑल दैट एंड देन आई वेंट इनटू माय रूम एंड नथिंग वाज प्लेइंग ओके ऑल द म्यूजिक एवरीथिंग वाज स्टॉप्ड एंड सडनली फ्रॉम द स्पीकर Eminem's lyrics started playing. Eminem's song started playing with a very Indian voice, which said, and it was more like not a singy-songy song. It just came out as "Guess Who's Back" in a very dual voice. And my Winamp Windows Media Player, nothing was running. All right, I just switched on my computer, and from the speaker, I heard somebody say, "Guess Who's Back." Back again. Aur mera itna gaan phat gaya, guys. Mera itna gaan phat gaya.
I have like, so many questions. There's a ghost who's into Eminem. And
maybe it was Arnold Schwarzenegger.
And respect that you're still using Winamp. So that's I support that. I support that.
I that's amazing. Can you tell me where you got it from?
No, this so is then, back kya, in the day.
Toh kya tha, Bill? What was it?
I don't know, man. Like it's still very mysterious about what it was.
Like all of my programs were shut down. This is wo zamana jabhi we had that white color ka computer na bada wala ekdam. Matlab computer chalu karke chai vai bana ke aane ka tab tak computer start ho jata tha. Waisa wala computer ka zamana hai.
Did you have a roommate or anyone?
No, nobody. This is like I was staying with my family tabhi.
But Suresh will know this about computers, sir. You're the expert on ghosts.
The computer hang ho raha tha while it was playing the girls who's back.
No, this is like ekdam fresh start, guys. Ekdam fresh start. And it really freaked me out.
So where exactly, which area was this?
In front of the computer, Suresh.
No. Where
which
were you
part of the world? Which part where of the world?
This is a place like Bhinder West. If you all have heard.
क्या anyway, Suresh, first Calvin. I'll
tell you
stop
why.
Stop the ghost who's moving your camera up, Suresh. Usko pulo niche lane ke liye. Somebody keeps moving his camera. Anyway, this is a good warm-up story. Thank you so much, Calvin. I hope your computer, you're not still using that computer.
Yeah, but listen,
no, I'm not
Calvin,
using that anymore.
Just download this new virus protection called Ghost Virus. It will take care of everything. Yeah, it's antivirus.
Is it one of your apps, Cyril?
Yes. Yes.
It's one of the aspects.
Yeah, because computer possession is on a high, and we've come up with an app that is a antivirus as well as an anti-possession.
Also, I've thought developed here. This app has got ghosts which will come and repair your computer.
Kya baat hai. This is exactly the kind of stuff I want, so that I can come back Calvin. On this theme again next week.
Thank you, Calvin, for this story.
Thanks for calling us.
I'll be back.
All right, guys. Bye, buddy. Have a good one. Big fan. Speak to you guys soon.
Same.
I'll be back.
I think that was the computer kind of like slowing down. Sometimes
you
that happens.
Let me complete, Hoezaay. But binder.
Yeah, I purposely didn't.
No, but I'm telling you that some of those areas over there, they feel as if I've seen once or twice 2-3 people crossing the road.
Achha, sir, yesterday somebody saying, na, Suresh sir keeps putting his finger up like that, but y'all are not giving him chance to talk and all. So but from now, don't put the finger up, sir.
Okay.
I'm just kidding. Sir, aap bindas, yesterday to you were on fire. People are like, Suresh sir, fire.
Hey, itna kya joke mara, main itna zor se acha, bahut din ho gaya.
Bahut. But sometimes I see Suresh is changing the fingers. It keeps on changing to which finger he's putting up, sir. I've noticed this.
Wo ishara de raha apne ko.
that is when I'm sitting on them.
This seemed more like a technical issue, and people were typing technical Guruji and all chat.
Yeah. But I get it. You know, anything can spook you out, and you can, you're automatically trying to figure out what's happening out there.
Ananya is connecting to audio.
Ananya, Paul is not in the country. I can tell you, on a hunch.
Hi, Ananya.
Hello.
How's it going?
Oh my God! I'm in the stream. Yeah, I've been watching you guys since you started this. And
so a couple of weeks
now.
Good,
and
good.
Cyril, you're right.
You're in New York.
You have a ghost story for us?
Yeah. I do. So this is a story of my friend, actually, not mine. So I started watching your stream, and like I was talking to about the stream and all the stories to my friend, and we both are scientists at this lab called Brookhaven National Lab.
Awesome.
So he came to visit me, and he was like, hey, you know, I was like, I'm listening to this stream, so ghost stories, do you want to hear some ghost stories? And he was like, no dude, I don't want to hear about any ghost story, because I get terrified, because I was possessed once. And I was like, what? And I'm like, yeah. And then he was like, remember I told you I got brain malaria? So when he was apparently in fourth or fifth standard, he got brain malaria. And he never... sorry?
That's the strain. It's called falciparum, I think. My mom had it. That's why I know. This malaria that affects the brain, right?
Right.
Thank you, Dr.
Jose. Sorry.
Yeah. Right. So, So then he said that he always used to tell me in bits and pieces that, you know, this happened to me when I had brain malaria and all of that. But then that day when I, when he like really told me what happened, he was like, I feel, I don't know if it was the brain playing games with me or I was really possessed by someone. He just, I asked him what's the last thing that you remember. And he said that, I remember one afternoon I was playing in this playground behind a community hall, and there was like a big jungle behind the playground. So he was just playing volleyball by himself by, you know, throwing the volleyball against the community hall. And he felt like someone, like a big animal like thing in the shape of a human. He was like completely hairy, just coming, running at him from the behind and just grabbing him. And he fainted over there. And then some, and then the next thing he remembers was that he's lying in his room, in his, and everyone is surrounding him, his parents and everyone. And he is, and he's having fever and he's saying things, like he can't remember. He know, he's, he remembers that there is some voice coming out of his mouth, but he can't remember what he's saying exactly. And then he says that, so I was like, I felt like my muscles were moving, but it was not according to what I wanted. Like, you know, like if someone as like my mom once asked me to turn the switch of the fan, and he could see that the switch of the fan is on the wall here, but then he felt like someone was inside him and someone was forcing his hand to go like, you know, like this way and that way. And not exactly hitting the switch. And then he felt like when he was like, he felt like he's in a trance or in a half conscious state. And that being or whatever, what it was inside him, it's saying that, you know what, I'll kill your parents. I'll kill everyone. And I'll make sure that you become my slave like this. Like, oh, and I'm God. Like, what the fuck, dude?
Yeah,
wow.
I was going to say exactly that.
And then, and then I was like, I don't believe you. Like, and I tried to, like, you know, search what happens when brain malaria happens. And I discussed this with my boyfriend, who is like a doctor. And he says that he told me that anything that affects the brain will force you to, you know, hallucinate and all of that. If you have fever, you know, if you have a temperature beyond 103 or 104, you will automatically start hallucinating. So yeah. I asked him, like, did you really feel all these things, or were you hallucinating? And as I was asked, I continuously asked him like bits and pieces, like questions that I had. And he was like, you know what, please stop asking me these questions, because I don't want to recall, because the more I recall, I feel like the more it is becoming real. Now I have forgotten it, like it's a bad memory. I felt like it's a memory. I was in a dream or something. And the more I try to think about it, the more it becomes real.
But so did he have fever at the time, or was ye sab malaria, brain malaria wo ho raha tha tab?
Right. Usko fever, as in, I guess usko aise raat ko fever aata tha, aur din mein wo thoda sa sahi rehta tha, like din mein paracetamol wagera usko dete the, to wo sahi rehta tha. But this then is, he felt like someone is speaking to him and someone is controlling his movements.
So Ananya, when he was playing basketball, he was playing ball on the court. At that time, he didn't have any symptoms, right? He was normal before he felt that hairy, big animal kind of thing run towards him, correct?
Right. So whenever he talks to me about this brain malaria thing, he's always like, you know, when I was in my fourth standard, I got brain malaria and all of that. And then I asked him, like, what is the last thing that you remember? Like, before you were possessed or something. And he's like, yeah, I was playing there and I was playing and I felt like someone just running from the jungle towards me and like grabbing me. And like, I think that is when that creature, whatever it like entered me.
Anyway, so are you still hanging out with this guy?
Can I jump in here? I got a theory.
Yeah, yes, he's a very good friend of mine.
Okay, just checking. Does he still feel like this?
Yeah.
No. He doesn't.
Paranormal expert Suresh.
Yeah, so I was just going to come to this anyway. So I want to know something.
It's Boris Johnson.
Where did this happen?
This happened.
Which area? Which area? Geography.
Oh, okay. Geography. It was in India. It was in Bhubaneswar. Okay. Actually, he's from Odisha.
Okay. For anybody wondering, Suresh is making a map of all the places people have told us ghost stories from. That's all.
He's starting his tourist service very shortly.
Birdie said it's going to be a color book, so you can also draw.
Have you? Do you know? Are you aware of this term, the reptilians?
Yes, I am.
Yeah. So these are like beings that people do not know they exist. There have been sightings all over the world of these people, and they are supposed to be aliens who are parked on Earth, and they have got the capability to become invisible.
I received it.
I'm not yet coming to that. But I want
not
to say
yeti.
There is footage of like even rappers like Lil Wayne and a couple of other people on YouTube. You can check it out. Someone's paused the video. His eyes roll up and then they come down again. It's crazy. Very freaky.
Anyway, okay.
Anyway, keep away from him for some time.
घर पे जाके ना बीन बजाना बीन बीन बजाना अगर वो नाचता हुआ
YouTube that I am saying the story about me, he'll be really mad.
See, Ananya, just remember one thing. Lizards get scared of eggshells. So in case you feel like there's anything recurring back, just keep eggshells around you. You'll be perfectly.
Look, I wouldn't want to piss off somebody who's hearing these voices and all. Anyway, but Ananya, thank you for calling us.
That is a crazy story.
Very creepy story. Very creepy stuff. Best of luck, and I suggest hanging out in the daytime only.
Yeah.
I don't know.
And no jungle area. This like
Take care, Ananya. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much, Ananya.
Thank you. Nice talking to you guys.
Nice meeting you too. Wow.
Hi, Ananya. That was rude. How to scare a lizard? Hello,
Cyrus,
my cutie patootie.
Bye to
her. Hey, welcome, Cyrus.
So nice to see you. My cuties, my girls, my boys, my brothers. I just got back from a very long gig. And
we told everyone that you were moving people's spotted plants. That's
I saw you running on the street behind my building a few minutes ago. I don't know.
That is me too. Okay. Listen, this situation that Suresh was talking about, I feel... Yeah. And I'm a believer, man. I think that there's some bunch of people that are living here on this planet and they're very powerful, right? Yeah. And they are reptilian, bro. There's a lot of footage of very
famous celebrities. Suresh has been watching Ancient Aliens also.
Yes.
We were talking about this last time.
Eric Von Daniken wrote that Chariots of the Gods, I think, or something, which is about numerous places, even the pyramids and stuff like that, and a superior race that lived. By the way, I would like to say that how to scare a lizard away, naphthalene balls.
Oh.
Not normal balls, naphthalene balls.
Okay. Yeah. Okay.
Pepper spray, eggshells, Tabasco sauce, and onions.
You're making a dish.
Oh. Other things to scare
a lizard. Guys, you can just say hur and make a sound and tap next to it. That also works.
Oh, hey, I told you guys, have I told you that I told you, Jose, once that I punched a lizard in the face.
Yes, you did.
I never treat them badly. I always, when I see
lizards, love lizards,
They eat cockroaches,
Very friendly.
They do.
They are such beautiful creatures, man. Yeah. If you they keep the house clean, they're chilled out.
We're doing this part for all the lizard people who are watching so that we don't get into trouble.
I was wondering, Cyrus.
The thing is, I believe that the Parsis are a dying race, but after I meet you three, check up on your DNA shit. There has to be some Parsi blood because every Parsi now, he will say one rude thing and he'll fucking double check and all and be like, actually, it's
like, okay, real quick. I'm just going to go through the Harami chat. 2,453 people on the stream, 24 minutes in. Thank you so much, guys. Don't forget to hit like and unlike dislike. Agar tumko achcha nahi lag raha hai, to achcha nahi lag raha hai. No one is forcing you. It's totally up to you. Having a personal conversation.
Can I say one thing though? It is really cute as a young couple to be twinning. Cyril and Hoezaay.
We did this on,
you know, we were supposed to do this on Sunday, but we thought we'd bring it up one more day earlier.
I don't know how this happened. What the hell?
Me and my best friend Sameer Kocher do it also. No, it's not. And it's beautiful. Listen, guys, it's beautiful. It's beautiful.
Okay, guys, we're matching underwear.
Okay.
That's fine.
Maverick X, thank you so much for saving me from those jokes and sending us a super chat. Utsav Nath says, someone could have changed the default startup sound to recording the first computer story. I also think someone did that to him.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe he did it.
Yeah, even himself. I was going to say the same thing.
Somebody says, this podcast is the reason underwear stonks are up. I don't know.
Hey, can I put how many people out there listening or watching this believe that before us there was a superior race that existed?
Oh, I believe.
I
come from there only.
You know, every great invention has happened in the last 150, 200 years max.
Yes.
Fuck was going on before that? There's so much evidence of shit happening.
We've triggered the scientist in Sahu, sir. We're ghost story.
Doctor, sorry.
But he's right.
Cyril, control your partner, bro.
Let me take this.
Please handle this.
This is just because you're a pessimist. Okay, doesn't mean that this is, and remember, Cyrus,
I'm a guest in your house.
I'm wondering that you make funny stories. Guess who's visiting you in the night?
Yeah,
stop it.
Jose, there's that neighbor. Guy, you know, you're asking for it.
Let me finish with these guys. Maverick again, thank you so much for your message. Let's go take another person on. Man, we got so many blank calls in the starting. I don't know who those people were, Cyrus, but yeah. I don't know about you guys. We were talking about this. That last time stream was really creepy, man.
What was that? Like, what was the story?
The guy's neck was broken. She was going up the tree and all. Fuck!
That was
those visuals stuck in my head.
Alibag on the tree.
Chetan, you're on the stream, buddy.
What is this picture, Chetan?
Obviously, you're not. We are not Chetan.
Portugal ne mar diya goal.
Have I told you today?
No, AJ, I do not.
I'll tell you about my. Dude, this mirror behind me is fucking shaking.
Hey, yeah, it is.
Hey, the bird and all is fine. The cage and everything.
The bird cage is over here. I'm telling you, it's over here. I take it off.
But last time I met you, you told me it was never there. There was never a bird cage.
The mind is missing with you, Suresh. What the fuck are you talking about?
Chetan, you made it.
That's simply awesome.
Get the fuck up.
Hello? I think we won't.
Chetan,
C has gone. Chetan, you have gone crazy.
Hello?
Yes, he's there. He's
hello, who's speaking?
I was really shocked. I didn't know I would get accepted into the Zoom meeting. This is a really
you have been accepted. This is even better than getting accepted into college. Go for it, buddy. Do you have a ghost story?
Yes, actually I do. This is it happened. My friend lives in Italy, so okay. It happened to her. It's like a story she told me. So
okay, now calm down, Chetan.
Chetan, they got it all
so out. So long, Chetan.
Yeah, they're possessed by various animals. We're fine now. Okay.
Chetan, we're all going to take a deep breath with you. Now it's your turn, Chetan. Go for it.
Yes, sir. So this all happened when we were watching Texas Chainsaw Massacre. And so towards the end of the film, with the character Leatherface, maybe some of you have seen it, you guys might know the film. So he's on the highway and he's got a chainsaw with him. So he's trying to kill people. And so, and all of a sudden in my room, I heard the chainsaw. Now I'm quite a skeptical person. Like, I have an explanation for this. So my monitor is, it's a TV monitor. So if I plug it into, if I plug my earphones into my computer, the volume from the TV doesn't work. So, and I'll get the volume directly. So I was using my earphones. And then, you know, a couple of days later, I told her about it as well. And she said, you know, I hear the lawnmower at 3 a.m. at night sometimes. And I said, what do you mean? Like, she said, yeah, sometimes once in a while I hear it. But she said early in the morning. And I was wondering, what do you mean by that? Yeah, she said there's like there's this. And she took a picture of her the building where she lives. Like she lives in somewhere in the suburbs of Naples, and she showed me the picture. And then she started telling me about it. Now there's a dude who lives there with his dog, and he's like a farmer. And then she started telling me more about it. And then she said, you know, like a long time ago when I was a kid, there was a ravine there, and there was this old man who used to like kill dogs and like throw them into the ravine. And then after that, there was some dispute, I guess, and they had to evict the guy or something, and they had to move him out of the vicinity. And then they built a building, like they built buildings over it, and it just became part of the houses there. And then, you know, like, and the weird part was that she kept telling me that, the point is that, and now there's a farmer who lives there, like with his dog, like on the ravine where they just used to kill street dogs. Like this dude, all this dude did was just kill street dogs. And now they had to get rid of that guy. They built a house, and now there's a farmer who lives there with a lawnmower and a dog. So like, she tells me like once in a while in the morning, like at 3 a.m, she can hear a lawnmower.
Oh, at shit. 3 a.m?
Wow. Yeah, for no... like.
What's he doing with that lawnmower, man?
No, it's not the farmer.
Oh. Oh, she just
hears... don't see anyone. Farmer, they just hear the...
the farmer person who was staying there.
It's the farmer. Yeah. Suresh on fire these days.
Chetan.
Chetan, I don't know you. I don't know you, but I love you, bro. You have the... You have such a reporter voice. And it's so, there is such sincerity in your voice. You remind me so much of
what do you do, Chetan?
Listen, for Chetan's story, part, part, please switch this video to 0.5x speed. And then when you come back over here. But Chetan, you were going to tell us about the chainsaw thing, na? Chainsaw ka awaaj kidhar se aaya?
I'm quite a skeptical person, actually. And then I was just in my room watching Texas Chainsaw Massacre. And for like a brief moment, I heard it in my room. Like, okay, so let me... So I live on the ground floor. And then on the first floor, there are new tenants who moved in. And on the second floor is my uncle. So on two occasions, tragedy has struck. My grandfather, he passed away on the second floor. And so, this is also really tragic. Like this year, this is a new family who moved in here. So it's like a... there's a husband and wife. They're like in their 50s, 40s, and they have two daughters. And the husband passed away of COVID.
Oh, so sorry.
It was very shocking, actually. It was just all abrupt, and it was all in the online article as well. So, and then, you know, and I'm quite a skeptical person. I have a theory is that the more you're skeptical, the more you're willing to believe that there are actually some sort of, you know, you want to be convinced. That's what I believe.
Yeah, I kind of get what you're saying. Okay.
But Chetan, I also have another theory to the, you know, the lawnmower and everything. There's a really popular gardening channel that you know, a lot of people do watch sometimes. Right?
At 3 a.m, maybe that person was watching.
It could be, you know, I'm just saying.
Or somebody was like mowing a lawn somewhere. That could also be this case.
Yeah, I mean, there's an app called Calm. You know, it plays like mowing sounds. It's possible. You're right. You know, you can psychologically psych yourself into believing these things are around you. It's a possibility.
Chetan, you're good now, na? Now there are no chainsaw sounds and all.
I'm quite skeptical about all these things, but when I do watch the stream, and when I do like, you know, watch all these people, see when you watch a film, right, you know, okay, it's fictional, but then when you have real people telling you these stories, you actually think, is this like actually happening to these people?
How many could go wrong, bro?
Yeah,
there has to be something we don't know, you know, we can't see, but it still exists.
Yeah.
I like how Cyrus brings credibility to this whole thing. That's the best part. But Chetan, I have a very important question to ask you.
Yes, sir.
Are you a skeptical person?
When it comes to ghosts and stuff, I'm very, very skeptical.
No, because I'm not sure if you're a skeptical person. Because,
he's also fence about this. But
you know, I'll tell you one thing, Chetan. You are such an awesome guy. I feel like in some lifetime, we would be friends.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah, bro.
After the lawnmower guy comes home with the lawnmower.
Yeah, you see.
When you're done mowing the lawn, Chetan, we sit and chat.
I had a moment with him. I asked him, "Why could I?" He didn't reply to me in Tamil.
because the chainsaw and the lawnmower was happening now. There was
अबे उसके घर में आत्मा घुस रही है, उसके घास काट रही है.
Want to become friends?
Where is it? Where location? Location?
Location? Yeah, that Naples already noted down.
Yeah, keep on listening to the stream, because towards the end of the stream we'll discuss how to deal with these things at home, right? We want to discuss a bunch of exercises to keep yourself calm. Yeah.
Chetan, thanks for calling us, buddy.
Yeah.
Sir.
Yes.
Think about Suresh, sir. Sir, I'm sorry I couldn't reply. I was just trying to answer everyone.
Are you
So one last small detail.
Show us your face, Chetan. Show us your face, brother. I gotta know who you are.
Chetan, we gotta see you, because I'm imagining that you're dodging someone while telling us the story. Hey,
show me your face, bro.
I love your background, Chetan.
And Death Stranding ka poster.
Death Stranding.
Boy.
I don't get scared in the night. You know, look at my background.
Chetan, wo Panvel ka train aa raha hai. Jaldi bol, bol. Kya scene hai last ka?
Chetan, can you repeat the word? I am a skeptical person.
I'm a skeptical person.
Now we have become skeptical.
Go ahead.
So this again. So you know, I'm I usually get dreams involving my. So I had a friend as well who passed away. He was quite young, 1920, And it was a pretty dark time in my life. And so then, you know, after he passed away, and then when I came back home from the funeral, like a few weeks later, I always kept getting dreams of like seeing him in my dreams, but he's always alive.
And normal, very normal. It happens.
That's kind of normal. That happens to a lot of people.
True, true.
Wow, bro.
And
it's a blessing also.
Yes, sir. So the thing about it is the what happens with my grandfather is that, like, I saw him when he died. So like when I was there, I witnessed it. So, and then whenever I get dreams with my grandfather, it's like he's always about to die. Like that's like this weird contrast I always have with like these two people.
Wow, crazy, bro! Wow. Thank you for sharing all these freaky stories.
Thank you.
Sounds like you have like 12 more things to tell us.
No, sir. Just one last thing, actually. Yeah, I'll be really fast.
Are very fast.
Faster, brother. Speed is not the problem.
The flash Vishwanathan.
Go ahead, Chetan.
Yes, sir. So what they do when I'm a Tamilian, so Mr. Suresh, of course, guessed it. So what they do is when like after a person dies, they have this ceremony where they place a pile of sand, like a flat piece of like grains of sand on a floor, and then the entire family gathers, and so they they switch out the lights at 1 o'clock. They keep all the family belong the paraphernalia that the loved one had, and they like have a puja. So the belief is that at 1 o'clock or 2 o'clock at this specific time, that these people come and they leave an imprint on the sand. Mm. Now there was a person in my family who had like a crooked hand, like his hand was like, you know, it was weird, it was crooked. So one time my mom, she went for the same ceremony that they had to do it. So they did it, and then my mom came back and she said, you know, in the night he showed up. It was like he came. We saw the imprint in the sand. Now I thought I believed her, but then when I grew up and then when it was like, you know, when my grandfather died and they did the same thing, I was waiting there at 1 o'clock in the night, and I was waiting and I really hoped he showed up, but you know, nothing happened. But you know, nothing happened, and you know, all my family members, they just saw one. There was some imprint already in the sand. They said, "Oh yeah, he showed up. Let's go." He just wanted to go home.
Yeah, I know. Fair enough, man. Chetan. But thank you for sharing that. It's a really sweet story, man. And when,
thank you guys. Yeah.
You take care, Chetan. Lots of love to you, man.
See you guys.
Best of luck.
Look after yourself, buddy. Thank you for turning that camera on.
Yes, sir. Bye, sir. See you guys.
You go, Chetan. You don't slow down.
Chetan, I
love Chetan, bro. He reminds me of like, he has that enthusiasm that, that mad energy and crazy conspiracy shit.
Like this time of the night, like he's just got all that energy.
Like I would cast Chetan as a roommate in a series or something like that.
Dude.
You know what I mean?
And you're like, Chetan, there's no brief, just go.
Cyrus, I want to take this opportunity and just say that your mirror is freaking the hell out of me right now.
Bro, I don't know.
I'm expecting it when it twists to the right. I'm going to see your face.
Somebody's face,
I'm going to see
in the mirror there. Why is that moving?
And I'm seeing shit like.
Like there is somebody opening the door.
There's like a silhouette of a face.
Cyrus, are you doing that with your leg?
Hey,
fuck.
What? Are you mad?
It's
a
leg.
What am I, rubber? Fucking rubber. My half orangutan or what? My leg's going to go there.
In the mirror. Man,
I'm seeing a face. I'm telling you, I'm seeing a face in there.
Hey, y'all are not seeing that moving in his mirror. Fuck you guys. Just fuck you.
That's what I'm saying. I saw, bought up the mirror moving.
Calm down. Let me arrange.
Sila, Sila, what the fuck?
Stop screwing around, guys.
Hey, but can okay. I adjust my hair in your mirror?
Sure. Sir, Jigun Ramesh says, what's with the mirror on the wall behind Cyrus? I need to know. Tell me, baby girl, because I need to know. The last three things you didn't say.
Should I leave it there or should I take it out?
It's fine. I just want to know what's moving there. None of you are, all you are behaving like nothing's moving there.
It's passing gas. It's okay. A lot of gas.
Please calm yourselves. Maverick again has sent another super chat. He sent like 6-7 super chats. Maverick, did you steal someone's credit card? Because I have a feeling he's just been sending super chats nonstop. But I appreciate it. As long as it doesn't get traced back to me, it's all good. But thank you, Maverick. Thank you, Maverick. Thank you, Maverick.
He just sent super chats like nothing.
I need to ask the people in the chat, Harami chat, are you all seeing that thing moving over there? There's something moving in Cyrus's mirror. Baba, and all these idiots are behaving like they don't see anything.
You know what is going to be freaky? Someone's going to zoom in on this chat later on and they're going to find some stuff.
Dude, I'm seeing a face. I can see a face out there. I'm just saying.
I can see a face.
Vikram, don't know.
I'm just saying.
Vijay Rai says, I have an extremely gruesome story. Been trying for 2 months. Please let me in.
Wow, let him in, man.
TK, Vijay.
But the stream has been on for less than 2 months.
Have you been on for 2 months? I don't think
roughly.
Suresh, your mind is gone. Fucking green.
Vijay, Rai.
Deepika, you need to put the YouTube stream off.
Have you shaved my toe, Ranbir? Deepika, are you there?
Deepika.
She's definitely there.
She's there because we heard the stream. She's like, no, I won't say anything.
She's like, they caught
me. She's not you. I feel like tonight's going to be one of those weird nights, you know, where some
look, I have no issues.
If someone who calls us is actually from the other side and we don't know.
Oh my God.
Maybe to be from the other side only.
Maybe
but
we are from the other side.
Hello.
Oh, she's here.
Take it easy, bro.
Vijay, we'll bring you back in. Deepika, the stage is yours. Tell us, kya bhoot ka problem hoge really?
Actually, I'm from Hyderabad. Okay, so.
Dude, that's freaking me out.
Yes. That's it. That's the story.
That's it.
That's
quite scary.
She muted herself. Deepika.
I can't hear you guys. Wait.
Oh my gosh. Do you have your earphones on? But then you wouldn't be able to hear that even. That's so stupid. Deepika, don't worry about us. You just tell the story. Chhod de. Deepika's like, fuck it. I don't care about these people enough to try harder.
Main peach ka raha hu, peach.
Vijay. Bechara Vijay aaya tha, ready tha wo.
Vikram.
I need something gripping tonight. Wrong pe khade kar dene wali kahani.
Listen, I'm happy. I'd be happy if not a single story on today's stream is scary because last time's stream really messed me up. Hi, Vikram. How's it going, buddy?
I was a big fan of all of you. I don't Thank want to you, waste Baba. Your time because Kitna? I have a long story. I don't think hum log convince na poche.
Abhi hum tumhare fans ban gaye because you said this. Kya baat hai?
Ahmed Khan dikh raha
hai. Shuru kar do. Go for it, Vikram.
Okay. So, ये जो story है ना ये मतलब मेरे को मेरी बुआ ने बताया था and this is from Malwan side मतलब अपना जो रत्नागिरी side वगैरह जो area वहाँ का story and this is a 100-year-old story.
Oh God.
So basically the story goes like that कि एक मतलब जब गांव अपने छोटे-छोटे गांव रहते हैं ना जहाँ पे मतलब bus नहीं जाता travel नहीं करते और this is before at the time of when मतलब कि जहाँ पे foreign अपने England के लोग थे अपने अंग्रेज लोग before independence so 1900 के स्टार्टिंग में तो बेसिकली हुआ क्या था एक छोटा सा गांव था मालवन साइड में जहाँ पे बेसिकली 50-40 घर सिर्फ थे जहाँ पे ज्यादा घर रहते नहीं थे तो वहाँ पे एक लेडी रहती थी सावित्री कहकर विच वॉज लाइक टेकिंग केयर ऑफ होल हाउस बिकॉज उसके घर में कोई मतलब कोई बड़ा आदमी नहीं था मतलब मेल पर्सन नहीं था शी वॉज वर्किंग इन फार्म एंड शी वॉज टेकिंग केयर ऑफ तो उस गांव में क्या था कि एक कुआ था जहाँ पे सब लोग बोलते थे कि वहां पे जाने का नहीं करते कि दैट इज हॉन्टेड सो बेसिकली पीपल यूज टू नॉट अलाउड टू गो देयर एंड वन डे शी बिकॉज वो कुआ जो था कोइंसिडेंटली उसके जो फार्म था उसके नियर बाय था उसके फार्म के नियर बाय था शी वन डे शी यूज द वेल टुक द वाटर फ्रॉम देयर तो गांव वालों ने उसके अगेंस्ट बहुत बोला क्योंकि वो मतलब अकेली औरत थी जो घर संभाल रही थी, तो ऑब्वियसली कि मुझे ना विधवा है, अकेली विधवा है, तो वो लोग ने मतलब बोल पैसे ऑपरेट करते थे पहले के वैसे ही था ना कि मतलब ध्यान रिस्पेक्ट नहीं करते थे उन लोग का। तो उसको उन्होंने मतलब पंचायत वगैरह बुलाया और उनको बोला कि बस ये नहीं चलेगा करके। शी अपोज्ड बिकॉज शी वाज स्ट्रांग वुमन, शी अपोज्ड कि नहीं ऐसा कैसा मेरे को वहां पे जरूरत है तो मैं आई विल यूज करके। तो फिर क्या हुआ कि उन्होंने बोला इतना देखो शौक है ना तो एक काम कर, तो पूर्णिमा की रात होती है वो टाइम पे जाके रात को यू हैव टू ब्रिंग आउट कि मतलब तेरे को वहां से एक कलसा पानी लेके आ, इफ यू आर एबल टू डू दैट वी विल अलाउ यू टू यूज दैट वे बिकॉज वी डोंट वॉन्ट कि मतलब कि तेरी वजह से पूरे गाँव को प्रॉब्लम होगा। तो उन्होंने उसको चैलेंज कर दिया एंड शी टुक द चैलेंज। सो आफ्टर 5-10 days व्हेन द पूर्णिमा मतलब फुल मून नाइट केम, she was working whole day normally what she worked and evening ko jaisa decide hua tha everyone went to their home and she left from the circle of the village ki main jaati hu karke theek hai now I'll go karke. So she went there and purane ko kaise rehti wahan pe stairs rehta tha niche jane ke liye to rassi wala nahi jo stairs se chal ke jane ka niche rehta tha to pani zyada matlab zyada pani nahi tha to she took the stairs and went down to the bottom of the well. Usne jab niche gayi तो वर्ट शीड उसे कलसा था तो उसे ऐसे झुकी और ऐसे कलसे में पानी से लेने के लिए झुकी तो वो उठने के पहले उसके सामने एक आदमी आके खड़ा हो गया। सो समवन इन व्हाइट वेयरिंग व्हाइट शर्ट एंड नॉर्मल जो इफ यू वांट टू इमेजिन यू कैन से कि मतलब जैसे कि अपना अन्ना जरे कैसे कपड़े पहनते थे टोपी व्हाइट टोपी एंड वैसे टाइप के कपड़े पहन के एक आदमी खड़ा था। सो शी नोटिस कि अभी कोई तो आया है तो आई डोंट मतलब कि उसको डर थोड़ा लग गया लेकिन शी वॉज स्ट्रांग तो उसने बोला कि मैं कुछ तो करती हूँ करके। तो उसने क्या कि उसका पैर पे पानी डाल के उसका पैर धोया, ऐसा पैर धोते ना जैसे मतलब किसी बड़े रिस्पेक्टेड आदमी का वैसे पैर धोया
उन्होंने उस अंकल के पैर धोए।
हाँ वो अंकल के पैर पे से पानी डाल के उनका जबकि पानी में खड़े लेकिन उसे जानबूझ के हाथ से ऐसे धोते वैसा जैसे किसी रिस्पेक्टेड आदमी का पैर धोते वैसे पैर धोया और फटक से खड़ी हो गई क्योंकि शी न्यू कि इफ आई वेट टू लॉन्ग ही विल किल मी मतलब पीछे से मार देगा करके। तो खड़ी हो गई तो उन्होंने फिर बोला फिर वो अंकल ने उसको देखा हंसे फिर उन्होंने बोला अभी काम कर तूने मेरा पैर पोछ धो तो दिया है अभी पोछ भी दे करके इन मराठी कि मतलब तू धुतले तो माझे पाय धुतले तो माझे पायाला मराठी था ना वहां पे माझे पाय धुतले तो पाय पुसून पण दे। तो उन्होंने बोला तो उसने वो समझ गया अगर मैं नीचे झुकूंगी तो ये मारेगा मेरे को। तो उसने क्या किया कि मैं अभी उसने क्या बोला कि अभी आप इतने रिस्पेक्टेड आदमी है और मैंने ऐसा दिन भर पूरा काम किया पसीने से खराब हुआ साड़ी है मैं क्या करती हूँ मैं नया साड़ी पहन के आती हूँ मैं घर पे जाती हूँ नया साड़ी पहन के आती हूँ एंड देन यू कम तो मैं आती हूँ फिर आपके नए साड़ी से पैर पोछूंगी ये खराब साड़ी से नहीं पोछना चाहिए करके आपका रिस्पेक्ट खराब हो जाएगा। तो उन्होंने बोला फिर कि ठीक है चलेगा लेकिन अगर तू नहीं आई तो वो लेडी ने क्या किया सावित्री ने क्या बोला कि अगर नहीं है ना तो एक काम करो आप आ जाना मेरे घर पे तुम लेकिन मुझे कैसे मालूम पड़े तेरा घर कौन सा है इतने बड़े गाँव में। तो उसने क्या बोला कि मेरे पूरे गाँव में मेरा अकेले का घर सफेद रंग का है तो एक ही घर है जो सफेद रंग का है वो मेरा घर है। उसने ऐसे ही बोल दिया जानबूझ के झूठ। तो बोला कि ठीक है ओके चल गया जा राजा ना अगर नहीं आए तो मैं कल तेरे को लेने के लिए आ जाऊंगा घर पे। सो शी केम आउट और अभी तभी कुछ हुआ नहीं उसको उसने आया और गांव के लोग सब वेट कर रहे थे उसका गांव के अंदर उसने आके बताया ऐसा ऐसा हो गया करके। तो फिर वो और उसको तबियत भी खराब होने लगी एकदम मतलब उसको बुखार वुखार जैसा होने लग गया। तो नेक्स्ट नाइट के पहले पूरे गाँव को लोगों ने व्हाइट पेंट कर दिया पूरा गांव व्हाइट पेंट हुआ ये और मतलब कि पूरे गांव को व्हाइट पेंट कर दिया और शाम को जैसे सनसेट होता है तो पूरा गांव घर बंद कर मतलब सबके दरवाजे बंद करे सब अंदर बैठे एंड नेक्स्ट डे से ये स्टार्ट हो गया कि शाम को सनसेट के बाद में एक जो 10-12 बजे के नियर बाय टाइम रहता है ऐसा फिक्स टाइम नहीं था 10-11 मतलब कि एकदम लेट जो खाना खाने के टाइम के बाद का टाइम होता है वो टाइम के बाद में ऐसा नॉक होएगा घर पे हर घर में लाइन से नॉक होएगा ऐसा एंड ही विल से धुतलीस पन पुसलीस नहीं मतलब यू केम एंड वॉश माय लेग बट डिडंट वाइप
शिट आई गॉट चिल
एंड दिस हैपेंड लाइक फॉर इयर्स 60-70 years दिस हैपेंड और ये मतलब अभी तक 80s-90s तक ये चलता रहा एंड दिस स्टोरी वाज कि वो गांव में चल रहा था धीरे धीरे गांव के लोग छोड़ के चले लाने लगे मतलब पोस्ट इंडिपेंडेंस ऑल्सो दिस हैपेंड और ये स्टोरी आया ग्राउंड पे जब 80s-90s के आसपास किसी रिपोर्टर को ये मालूम पड़ा और उन्होंने पेपर में प्रिंट किया ये कि ऐसा एक गांव है जहाँ पे ये होता है एंड दिस इज नियर माय मालवन एंड राइट मतलब उसके बाद में वो गांव थोड़ा मतलब गायब हो गया अभी वो एक्चुअली स्टोरी इंटरनेट पे नहीं ट्राई टू फाइंड दैट नेम बिकॉज कि मैं आपको बोल दूंगा कि ये गाँव है करके, पर वो इंटरनेट पे स्टोरी मिला नहीं, ये स्टोरी में बुआ ने बताया क्योंकि बुआ के एक मतलब कि हस्बैंड के साइड का जो रिलेशन रहता है ना, समवन फ्रॉम दैट गांव मतलब नेटिव मतलब गांव से बिलोंग करता था, उन्होंने कंफर्मेशन दिया कि हाँ हम लोग गांव में ऐसा था करके, और शाम को वहां पे रात को कोई जाता नहीं था, मतलब वहां पे शाम को अलाउड ही नहीं था, वहां पे ना अंदर आने को ना बाहर जाने को, एंड एवरी डे दैट हैव यूज्ड टू हैपन अराउंड 60-70 इयर्स एवरी डे. That was the story.
What a story, bro. Thank you for sharing.
What an amazing village, by the way.
Multiple habubus.
Sorry, Suresh, you were saying something.
I think it must be happening even now. How do you know it's not happening now?
Maybe because अभी ये मतलब जितना मुझे पता है कि वो गांव अभी शायद तो मतलब पूरा बोलते हैं ना कि
लेकिन कहते हैं कि अगर वो नॉक कर रहा है तो दरवाजा कभी खोलना नहीं चाहिए, है ना?
नहीं खोलता,
अगर खोला तो यू विल बी पोजेस्ड, ऐसा कुछ.
अभी डोंट नो बिकॉज़ आई डोंट मतलब ऐसा भी मेरे पास मतलब पता नहीं है कैसे किसी ने खोल के
स्टोरी यहां तक पहुंच चुकी
है. यू विल बी वाइपिंग समवनस फीट.
ऐसा एक बार मेरे दोस्त के साथ हुआ था. दीस पीपल ही ओपन द डोर एंड ही गॉट पोजेस्ड. पूरा घर को ही पोजेशन ले लिया लोग ने.
वाओ,
दिस मनी लेंडर्स हु जिसने घर के लिए पैसे दिए.
ओ दे पूरा पोजेशन ले लिया, सब टीवी
पूरा पोजेशन ले लिया. देयर वर जोक्स अबाउट दिस इज क्वाइट स्कैरी मैन.
व्हाट इज द लाइन इन मराठी दैट ही सेज
धुतलीपन पुसलीस नहीं
धुतलीपन.
माय मॉम यूज्ड टू से द सेम थिंग टू मी but for washing things at home and all, but wo chodo bro bahut humko
thank you Vikram,
unnerving kar diya.
just closing bola. I like all of you, bahut bade fan of sabka, main bahut acha bahut fan hu, matlab sabko main follow karte rehta hu hamesha. Suresh Menon ko matlab bahut time zamane se matlab ki ekdam time
se maybe isko follow kare zaman se.
wo Suresh hi hai wo aadmi jo aake tak tak karta hai, bolta hai dutte ke putli nahi. You know, yeah, boo-boos. But I love the story has everything, you know. It's the story of the village coming together.
It's not a story. When you think about it, if you're staying in a village like that, I would freak out. I would not even want to open the door, let alone. I think it's cool of the village to all come together and paint their houses.
But village folklore is like that. Like in Norway or something, they say, you know, that they found hooves marks on the tops of all the, it's just snow in this village, and they found the marks of hooves. Because they believe that certain months in the winter, the devil would come. Like a goat.
Yeah, it's a goat.
Tramp, and then they found this everywhere, and they would shut the door. And if there were three knocks on the door, tuck, and if you open the door after the three knocks, this person would possess your family, and you'd have 50 years of bad luck.
What a beautiful time that was, right, to live in. Because right now, people knock on a door, like, oh, fuck, there's some creep or someone, you know.
So who's knocking now?
Bro, now there's someone knocks first to wear a mask, then you wear a shield. Then you're like,
bahar chhod do. Someone's knocking, I'm like, oh, is it the devil or is it my neighbor? Yeah. I'm not sure. Yeah.
But what a wonderful opening for a story, huh? Where the devil comes to visit.
Dude, oh my amazing. God,
what's happening? Hey, there is a haunted village in Bangalore.
Who's this?
Oh, don't.
Vishaka.
I don't see what.
Yeah.
But you know, wells and all, man, really, really creepy.
Wells will freak me out. Some people think they portal to another world also. You
so know? They portal to the folk stories, because even like my family grew up in a lot of like, you know, villages before it became cities, right? And they believe that wells were portals to the dead.
Vishaka! Vishaka, you made a
Vishaka, what is this scary behavior? Yeah. You know that we are all very vulnerable people.
Ek second, tum log TV pe dekh rahe ho sab.
What is this Vishaka like?
Are there's a ghost behind you?
Are koi hai tumhare piche?
Look at you guys, man. Aise faltu mein dara rahe ho log.
Is that a real person?
That's my husband.
Is it Thakur?
Huge fan, guys.
What's up, bro?
Jose, I love you, man.
Love you too, buddy. Vishaka, same pinch. Vishaka, ready?
My God, this is very unexpected.
Why is he crawling away?
क्या ये लोग इतना नर्वस होते हैं, और मैं अभी मेरा भी हार्ट
गुड गुड. ये आपके पति देव पीछे ठीक चल रहे हैं.
हाँ, भागो भागो जल्दी.
So I'll just get टू द स्टोरी
yes.
ये एक्चुअली मैं जब अपने रूममेट के साथ रहती थी तब हुआ था आई थिंक बैक इन 2017 एंड शी एक्चुअली हैड लॉस्ट हर ग्रैंड मॉम जस्ट लाइक अ वीक बैक या सो सो शी वन डे व्हाट हैपेंड कि वो सो रही थी और उसने रात को मतलब मेरे रूम में नॉक किया ठीक है तो मैंने मुझे लगा क्या हो गया उसको तो वो आके मुझे बोल रही है कि मुझे लग रहा है कि माय ग्रैंड मॉम इज हियर एंड हर ग्रैंड मॉम वाज इन वेस्ट बंगाल इन इन नॉट इन कोलकाता अनदर सिटी एंड शी हैड पास्ड अवे एज आई सेड एंड वी वर इन बैंगलोर सो आई लिव इन बैंगलोर एंड तो उसको लगा कि मुझे कुछ लग रहा है ऐसे कि वो है यहाँ पे तो बट शी वॉज ओके इट वॉज नॉट दैट बैड फिर कुछ दिन बाद शी सेड दैट आई थिंक आई लाइक शी वॉज स्लीपिंग एंड शी सॉ लाइक अ वाइट एक वो होता है ना हेज जैसा इट पास्ड थ्रू हर रूम एंड शी सॉ एंड आई मीन शी कुड फील दैट इट वॉज हर ग्रैंडमा तो वो एक इंसिडेंट हुआ ठीक है एंड वी ऑल लाइक सॉर्ट ऑफ फॉरगॉट अबाउट इट एंड शी कुडंट गो फॉर हर फ्यूनरल क्योंकि उसका ऑफिस था एंड आई मीन शी सडनली लाइक शी वॉज सिक फॉर अ लॉन्ग टाइम एंड शी पास्ड अवे सो देन शी थॉट कि आई विल बी गोइंग टू माई होम टाउन एनी वे आफ्टर अ फ्यू मंथ्स सो देन यू नो आई कांट गो नाउ सो शी कुडंट गो फॉर हर फ्यूनरल देन क्या हुआ जम्प टू वन मंथ लेटर one of my brothers from Calcutta who has like freaky sixth sense okay like he has been having you know
visions
experiences yeah visions or matlab unke sath bahut kuch hua hai wo to main nahi bolungi abhi I'll just stick to this story so he came to visit me in Bangalore and he was there and we were partying like koi aisa mahol hi nahi tha ki hum log matlab bhoot ka baat kar rahe hain because that is our favorite topic So we actually went out Indiranagar mein, we like sort of partied and then we came back and achanak se pata nahi kya hua we sort of shifted to talking about my roommate's this incident ki usko aisa feel hua ki uski grandma aayi thi and suddenly I don't know what happened my brother he just stopped speaking we were all sitting together on the bed And he just stopped speaking and he just started staring at my roommate and we sort of started feeling awkward ki kya ho gaya hai and he's like tumhari nani ke baal kaat diye the because she was sick and she had really long hair and they couldn't manage it and because she was bedridden to did you cut her hair short and my roommate went like yes but ye aapko kaise pata to unhone bola ki mere bhaiya ne bola ki usko acha nahi laga ki aap logo ne unka baal kaat diya tha she really loved her hair and she was very upset when her hair was cut aur ekdam straight face then we started going a little the thing became a little weird and then he said did she wear a big bindi like Bengali women usually wear a big red bindi and my roommate was like yes and she didn't know any he didn't know anything about her grandma and then my brother is like she is very sad that you couldn't go and meet her she's actually waiting for you and she's tried to tell you that she's disappointed and that she wanted to see you one last time so make sure that you go and meet her and he named where she has to go that place where she was from and then suddenly he as if he came out from
a trance
and he was like he knew what he was speaking yeah it was not ki unko yaad nahi tha wo kya bol rahe to fir unhone ekdam se bola ki please don't mind maine mujhe लगा कि तुम्हारी नानी शी इज ट्राइंग टू से ऑल दिस एंड इट वॉज लाइक शी इज सेइंग आई मीन आई डिडंट नो एनीथिंग इट आई जस्ट स्टार्टेड ब्लरिंग ब्लर्टिंग आउट सम यू नो दीज थिंग्स एंड देन माई रूममेट स्टार्टेड क्राइंग बिकॉज शी डिडंट एक्सपेक्ट दिस टू हैपन एंड it was like he got possessed but not really possessed but he became a means
he became a medium
he became a medium to tell her to give her this message yeah and then we all like sort of freaked out because unhone kabhi unko pata bhi nahi tha ki unki grandma matlab unke lambe baal the ya wo she was bedridden for a long time he didn't know anything and he just had that And we all knew that he had sixth sense, but this was the first time jab hame aise like mujhe in person I saw this happening in front of me. And then a few months later, she did go and she did visit that house. And she was very adamant ki nahi mujhe us ghar mein jana hai. Us ghar mein actually abhi koi rehta nahi hai. Kyunki after she passed away, everybody, you know, sort of that house is out for sale. But she went to that house. And after that, I mean, nothing has happened. But that was one episode that happened ki we saw somebody speaking for someone.
Yep.
And that was very, very creepy.
Wow, that's creepy, man.
Vishaka. That was and you know what's really crazy is that, you know, like they've reached out from beyond to finish the story,
and,
right?
Yeah, and the thing is, I mean, my brother didn't even know my roommate. We speak the same language, there's no reference.
He couldn't have faked this
and my brother has never traveled he doesn't travel like Bangalore chale gaya yahan chale gaya because he has lots of pets he never travels but that trip he made after a long time and it was just a few weeks later that all that happened with my roommate to hame aisa lag raha tha ki ye aisa timing hai ki wo out of nowhere he has come to Bangalore and that's when this is happening with her like the timing was just surreal like it's like unka yahan aane ka koi plan nahi tha and but he came and this episode happened
thank you crazy, Shaka, freaky, that's crazy story. Man
yeah,
thank you for sharing that
it's weird
man. Unless they're friends on Facebook
we're just trying to cope with the story.
Yeah.
Bizarre,
this is our
right?
coping mechanism.
Like, no, every time we have to do that.
Yeah.
And I must also, say, my sixth sense is telling that your husband is scared of ghosts.
Yeah.
I don't know.
And let me tell you why. Because
I'm not.
Suresh is actually a medium.
Harabi chat ka pad raha tha main.
But thank you for the story, Vishaka. Now you can put him back to work. I know he was pressing your legs just now.
No. I just want to say I'm like as everybody tells, huge fan. Suresh sir, आपका तो कहने में क्या हर्ज है वो विक का अरे 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 क्या मतलब
अरे जाइए ये तो साजिद खान वो जो विक का करता था जस्ट सी
Wow, this is a good look. I like this.
Beautiful.
Thanks.
This is very attractive.
Thank you guys. Thank you so much. Have
thank
a good night.
Thank you.
Bye.
Thank you. Bye, Vishal.
You're a good husband, bro. Good job.
Yeah, good job.
Yeah. Keep it up, bro. Keep it up.
जल्दी से इसको खत्म कर दे आप तब वाइफ से देख के तो बोलेगा कि क्या है सर
देगा Suresh see how he's pressing her legs? What about you? What are you doing?
Yeah, bro.
This lady looks like Malishka.
Yeah, Sanjana Palai.
I thought I clicked Sanjit, but some.
But if you believe in spirits, then that means you have to believe that there is a soul also, you know.
Of course.
Yeah. There is.
You have to believe that there is energy beyond what we are, right?
I told you earlier about this. Now I used to miss my mom such a lot, and one day I got a dream. I used to keep on, you know, standing in front of a photograph, wishing that she had come back and all this stuff. So one night I got a dream where my mom is standing with her hands like this wide.
Mm-hmm.
And she's telling me, Malayalam, why are you harassing me? And she's being pulled by both sides like this.
Shit.
What?
I woke up next day morning. I just went home to my dad and I told him this has happened. And he said, see, I told you, now let people go. Learn how to let go.
Oh, you told us this story. That's crazy.
Right. What a thing to happen.
I thought I picked Sanjeev.
But if you believe in spirit, then
Sanjana, you need to put YouTube on.
Sanjana, we are going to watch the stream again after this.
So yeah. Sanjana, how are you?
Hi guys.
Hi, Kasakai. Do you have a ghost story to tell us?
Yes, yes, maybe. I do. Can you hear me, guys?
We can.
We're loud and clear.
I love you guys. I'll just get straight to my story. I'm a little nervous. Sorry.
We love you even more. Take a deep breath.
And exhale.
Hi. So,
aram se bol do, no stress.
So my story is, the story that I'm going to say is my own story. So even my favorite topic is about ghosts. I talk a lot about ghosts with all my friends and everything. But I had never experienced this until in 2016-17 when I had gone to Alibag with my... So we are in Mumbai. So me and my husband back then when we were dating. Give me one second.
No problem. Give him a slap.
Alibag mein kaafi bhoot hai. This is the second or third, fourth story.
Alibag ki kahaniyan hai, bhootiya kahani.
Or tree. Let me see if it's going towards the tree.
Yeah, so yeah, hum log gaye the. So we used to do night shift back then. So Friday night we did a night shift and Saturday morning we logged off and we checked into a hotel in Nagao. So we used to stay usually in Nagao only. So uske pehle bhi hum log Alibag gaye the, but lekin we didn't experience anything as such. But that was the time when we had checked into a new hotel, very newly created, newly made hotel in Nagao Beach, just 1 kilometer away. So yes, hum log Saturday subah log off karke gaye, and then since we had done night shift, so hum log so gaye, we couldn't go to the beach. So sham ka yehi plan tha ki we'll go and visit the beach, and hum log gaye aur so basically वहाँ पे जैसे कि वो सेटअप है कि मतलब घुसते ही लेफ्ट में सारे चाय वाले होते हैं, राइट में एक ओपन पार्किंग होता है और बीच में सब वुड वाला ट्री वाला एरिया है एंड देन बीच. तो हम लोग गए तो वहाँ पे काफी मतलब 6:15 की बात है और लेकिन काफी अंधेरा हो गया था. तो वहाँ पे एक ही स्टॉल खुला था. तो मैं हम लोग गए उनको पूछा कि बीच चालू है क्या, तो दिया लाइक हाँ हाँ चालू है जा सकते हैं. एंड वी सॉ कपल मतलब कुछ लोगों को हम लोग ने जाते हुए देखा भी, मतलब दो कपल थे जो गए थे. तो पहले ठीक है ओपन है तो जाते हैं. तो मतलब हम लोग ने घोस्टली थिंग एक्सपीरियंस मतलब ऐसे एक्सपेक्ट नहीं किया था. हम लोग को लगा कि शायद सेफ्टी वाइज लड़की है तो जाना चाहिए नहीं जाना चाहिए वैसा. तो हम लोग देखा कि लोग जा रहे हैं तो हम लोग जाते, हम लोग थोड़ा बस भूख लगा था तो हम लोग गए स्नैक्स लिए और हम लोग डायरेक्ट अंदर चले गए. अंदर गए तो वहाँ पे ऐसे चार पेड़ के बीच में लाइक ऐसे स्लैंड बाइक हमने पार्क किया और हम लोग अंदर थोड़ा बीच साइड पे गए. दो ही मिनट रुके थे मतलब जब वी वर जस्ट ट्राइंग, तो खाली मूनलाइट था और हम लोग बीच पे थोड़ा रुके और उसके बाद हम लोग वापस वो वुड के इधर जहाँ पे हमने अपना बाइक स्लैंड पार्क किया था वहां आके हम लोग खड़े हो गए. एंड मैं बहुत आई एम अ बिलीवर, सो मुझे आई एम फ्रॉम ओरिसा एंड वहाँ पे थोड़ा लाइक एंड माई मॉम इज बॉर्न एंड रेज्ड इन कोलकाता, सो वी बिलीव इन ऑल दिस स्टफ. सो मुझे मतलब माई हेयर वॉज ओपन एंड आई कुड फील वेरी नेगेटिव वाइब्स देयर मतलब. एंड ऐसा नहीं है कि इट वॉज द फर्स्ट टाइम वेन आई एक्चुअली फेल्ट सम नेगेटिव वाइब्स, बट वहाँ पे वेन मतलब इट वॉज डार्क एंड वी वेर इन द वुड एरिया एंड ऑल. तो वहाँ पे कैसा हो रहा था कि आई कुड फील कि मतलब नोबडी टचिंग एनीथिंग एज सच, मतलब किसी ह्यूमन टच नहीं, बट आई कुड फील दैट समथिंग जब विंड पास हो रहा है नो आई कुड फील दैट यू नो समथिंग इज टचिंग हियर, समथिंग इज टचिंग माई थाइज लेग्स यू नो समथिंग लाइक दैट. And I was very uncomfortable. और मेरे husband जो है वो मुझे चिढ़ा रहा था, no, he was making all those ghostly sounds and all, he was making fun of me. So we were standing ऐसे सामने सामने, his back was facing the beach and my back was facing the exit. So हम लोग ऐसे खड़े रहके बात कर रहे थे and he was trying to take a selfie with me and all. So I was not very मतलब very uncomfortable. So like नहीं जाते यार यहाँ से जाते हैं. तो he's like अरे रुक ना यार क्या डरती है तू and this that and the normal talks. And then वो bike का ना moonlight में photos भी click करने लगा and मैं इधर उधर देख रही थी and थोड़ी ही distance पे ऐसे लोगों की आवाज भी आ रही थी बात कर मतलब करने की, मतलब it was ऐसा लग रहा था कि बहुत नजदीक है बट शायद दूर में लोग थे वहां पे बात बात कर रहे थे बट हम लोग को पता नहीं. उसके बाद बस ऐसे ही सडनली मजाक उड़ाते उड़ाते ही जस्ट सेड कि जल्दी बाइक पे बैठ जा. तो मैंने उसको कुछ पूछा नहीं क्योंकि मुझे तो निकलना ही था वहां से, तो मैं बैठ गई उसके पीछे और हम लोग निकल गए. एंड वो कुछ बोल ही नहीं रहा है
एंड हम लोग कुछ हम लोग टूवर्ड्स होटल जाने लगे, लाइक चलते चलते होटल जाते हैं. तो मैंने ठीक है, हम लोग जब जाने लगे और वहां पे जो, और मैं जानबूझ के कुछ नहीं पूछ रही थी बिकॉज मुझे रियलाइज हो गया था कि कुछ समथिंग हैपेंड, बट आई वाज इनट श्योर. तो ही इज लाइक सी आई एम गेटिंग गूज़बम्स आल्सो. तो मैं उसको देख रही थी ना, हाँ ही वाज एक्चुअली गेटिंग गूज़बम्स. सो वी वेंट और हम लोग, और जो हम लोग का होटल का जो रास्ता भी था ना वो भी थोड़ा क्रीपी था, मतलब अंधेरा था. और एक एक ब्रिज ऐसा आता था जो ऐसा सीमेंट वाला ब्रिज, स्टोन वाला जो ब्रिज होता है वैसे, और उसके वो पानी जो नीचे से पास हो रहा है ना वो भी पूरा सुनाई दे रहा था. इतना वहां पे पिच मतलब ऐसे साइलेंस था, तो थोड़ा क्रीपी ही था वो. तो हम लोग गए, होटल पहुंच गए, उसके बाद हम लोग तुरंत रूम में नहीं गए, हम लोग पहले वहाँ नीचे जो जहाँ पे स्विमिंग पूल था वहाँ पे जो चेयर्स लगे थे वहां बैठे. तो मैंने उसको बोला चल थोड़ा काम डाउन हो जा, क्या हुआ मेरे को पता. तो ही इज लाइक कि आई सॉ समथिंग. आई एम लाइक क्या देखा तूने बता मेरे को. तो ही सेड कि ही सॉ लार्ज एस अ ब्लैक टॉल ब्लैक एंटिटी
एंड
मतलब साइड ऑफ आई से देखा उसने, मतलब व्हाइल ही वाज मेकिंग फन ऑफ मी उसने ऐसे देखा कि समथिंग मतलब. और वो दो वुड के बीच में इतना डिस्टेंस था कि एटलीस्ट इफ अ ह्यूमन वॉक्स फ्रॉम वन ट्री टू अनदर ट्री इट विल टेक हिम एटलीस्ट 10 टू 12 स्टेप्स. और उसने बोला कि एक ऐसा एंटिटी मैंने देखा जो सिर्फ दो स्टेप में ये ट्री से आ गया है. एंड इट फेल्ट इवन इफ इट वॉज गोइंग फ्रॉम वन ट्री टू ट्री बाय साइड ऑफ द आई इट वॉज फीलिंग एज इफ इट इज कमिंग टूवर्ड्स मी. एंड मेरी फट गई, मतलब उसकी फट गई. तो इसने मुझे बोला कि जल्दी बाइक पे बैठा. और हम लोग जब डिस्कस कर रहे थे हम दोनों की फटी हुई थी. एंड फिर हमने गूगल सर्च किया कि हॉन्टेड स्टोरीज अबाउट नगाव एंड वी एक्चुअली फाउंड अ कपल ऑफ स्टोरीज जिसमें कि वी वर नॉट द ओनली वंस हु हैड एक्सपीरियंस दिस. दे वर seen black entities either sitting on the tree or you know moving between the trees aisa. So it felt really real. Hum dono ki phat gayi thi. And the story doesn't end here also. Hum log ek dusre ko calm down kiya, hum gaye khana wana khake. नहीं पहले तो हम लोग जैसे ही रूम में पहुंचे हम लोगों ने अपना रूम खोला, there was this weird insect in our room जो कि पता नहीं कहाँ से घुसा. और उसका जो होटल का स्ट्रक्चर कैसा था ना कि जो हम लोग सबसे ऊपर वाले फ्लोर पे थे और ऐसा लंबा लंबा स्ट्रेच था, मतलब लंबा बालकनी या ओपन एरिया टाइप्स था बाजू 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 में रूम. और पूरा दूर दूर तक सिर्फ फील्ड्स था, सिर्फ फील्ड्स, कुछ दूसरा होटल नहीं कुछ नहीं. बाजू में होटल्स थे बट सामने कुछ नहीं था. और वो इंसेक्ट पता नहीं कहाँ से आ गया अंदर. तो हमने होटल स्टाफ वालों को बोल के वहां उन लोगों को निकाल दिया उस कीड़े को. और उसके बाद फिर हम लोग खाना वाना खा के हम लोग रूम में ही ऑर्डर किया, खा के हम लोग सो गए. मतलब नींद तो नहीं आई हम लोग को, लेकिन रात भर मतलब है ना हम लोग के रूम के बाहर है ना कुछ तो वियर्ड बर्ड्स के ना आवाज आ रहे थे. मतलब इट वाज, आई डोंट नो इफ इट वाज क्रो और इट वाज व्हाट, वी डोंट नो, बट कुछ तो वियर्ड ही बर्ड के आवाज आ रहे थे. आई तो कुडंट स्लीप द एंटायर नाइट एंड ही वाज अस्लीप, लाइक वो सो रहा था फिर उठ रहा था और पूछ रहा था आर यू ओके एंड दिस दैट. बट इवन ही वी बोथ कुड हियर. एंड प्रॉब्लम ये है कि बर्ड्स ठीक है आके उस रुके भी होंगे बट इन दिस लॉन्ग स्ट्रेच ऑफ फील्ड्स वो बर्ड किसी ट्री पे नहीं जाके वो होटल के इधर क्यों आएगा. एंड हम लोग के ही रूम के बाहर वो आवाज क्यों आ रहा था, वी कुड नेवर फिगर आउट. बट बैक देन दूसरे दिन हम लोग जब मुंबई आ गए तो उसके बाद फिर भी मतलब कुछ हुआ नहीं है सच, बट इट वॉज रियली स्कैरी एक्सपीरियंस.
यू नो द ओनली थिंग आई कैन थिंक ऑफ टू काम माई सेल्फ डाउन आफ्टर दिस स्टोरी इज दैट यू गाइज वॉक्ड इन ऑन बैटमैन टेकिंग अ डंप ऑन द बीच.
And he does that apparently.
Yeah.
And that in Alibaba.
Yeah. Alibaba. Baap re.
Bottom city.
Can I ask you, Sanjana, this entity that he described it, it's typically long looming with like beady-ish eyes, like it's like hollow white or silverish. Is that what you all?
I don't know if they went that close to it.
No, I'm sure he saw it, right?
Felt it. So we searched a little bit about that gun also. No, somebody is Rakshas gun, somebody is Dev gun.
But वो तो personality होता है. वो तो
Ajay Devgan.
हाँ मतलब पता नहीं. But शायद I am that part of person जो मैं feel कर पाती हूँ, but I can't see. But
you can sense. Yeah.
I know what has happened. Yes, Rod, I've solved the whole thing. So basically, remember the first narrator, she had told us about a friend who got possessed by this same similar being, and that being rushed towards him and caught him. Okay, and now that being, after leaving him, now he's roaming in Alibag from Bhubaneswar.
Superb, wonderful. We have to call the scientists, we need to restrain Lord Suresh.
Yeah, thank you, Sanjana.
Thank you very much for sharing your story. To you and your husband, best of luck.
Yeah.
And don't look in the rear view mirror.
Big fan of you guys. So before you...
Thank you so much, Sanjana.
He's been following you guys since long, long years. I've been following you for a couple of years and I love you guys. You guys are great.
Thank you. Please don't stop these ghostly sessions.
I'll come back again.
As long as we're not too scared, we will come to you.
I have many ghost stories, so I'll
Next time, Sanjana.
Bye, Sanjana. Thank you.
Thank you.
I just want to take this opportunity to say first, we keep on thanking the narrators and the orators, but we don't thank the spirits for doing the hard work.
Yeah, that's beautiful, bro. Yeah, beautiful.
Let's thank the spirits.
We are doing everything we can to cover our asses over here.
For people, unnerved.
And also, spirit, if you can lend me some money.
Can you guys?
Also, spirit, I want a foot massage. I'm so sleepy today.
Cyrus, you remember you told me what about mocking the spirits, huh?
We are not mocking.
Listen, a lot of people are freaking me out about that mirror. Is there, some
there is
shit
something moving
there.
Don't be, I the mirror know is you know
moving.
It's
there. The it's mirror not is moving.
The mirror is not moving. There's a door over here that's on this side that's moving.
The wall is moving.
Which is across from Cyrus, I think.
The door is here, yes. But the mirror is moving because of the fan.
Can you open? Mirror is moving then. Thank God. Thank you for solving that. I was like,
I don't want to tell you this, but you don't have any fans in that room.
Man, go.
That's a double-edged joke.
You know, I have worked for 12 hours and I've come home and I have to deal with Shakespeare's wit.
Matlab.
All right. Rohan, Tuwari,
you wonder here. Ye toh atma bhi kar, even the spirit would be like, dekho bhai, main tha. But please, I want to discuss this towards the end.
Now, at least listen, now the guy who has been non-stop typing, I saw a woman in Cyrus's mirror. You can stop now. We've just discussed it.
What? Oh, listen, there's a hairband also. So the thing is that maybe they're seeing a hairband. There's a hairband behind the door.
Rohan, tu hai kya bhai?
Big fan. Thank you so much. Immediately joined कर लूँगा.
तिवारी साहब, genre क्या है horror कहानी की? आत्मा, भूत, voodoo.
आत्मा और एक voodoo. क्या बात है?
कैसे पता?
Voodoo से याद है. How do you do?
I'm doing great. I hope the same for you guys.
Thank you.
और ये जो दोनों स्टोरी है, एक तो authentic real है, पेपर में आ गया था.
Everybody watching right now is saying very smooth. दोनों स्टोरी ऐसा बोल के शुरू में ही दोनों.
नहीं,
you get a chance to tell only one story, sir.
अगर तुम्हें एक कहानी बताने का चांस मिले, रोंगटे खड़े कर देने वाली कहानी.
You're about to be devoured by the ghost. This is your last story.
Yeah.
दोनों सही है, लेकिन ठीक है. मैं
प्लीज फॉरगिव अस, बहुत लोग हैं ना लाइन में, देन इट विल बिकम.
हां, डन है. मैं एक ही स्टोरी आप लोगों को.
ओके सर, थैंक यू. हीरा आदमी है. गाइस, ड्रॉप हीराज फॉर हिम इन द चैट. गो फॉर इट.
थैंक यू.
गो अहेड रोहन.
सो ये वाला जो स्टोरी है, ये इसका ऑफ कोर्स ये पेपर वगैरह में नहीं आया था, बट ये हम लोगों को जिसने बोला था वो मंदिर का बंदा है, क्योंकि मैं खुद एक मंदिर से एसोसिएटेड हूं. सो आई एम एक्सपेक्टिंग कि उसने हम लोग को ये रियली बोला रहेगा. वो प्रीस्ट है, ब्रह्मचारी है. मतलब मैं इस्कॉन से, पॉसिबली शायद आप लोगों ने ये मंदिर का नाम सुना रहेगा, हरे राम हरे कृष्णा मंदिर. सो हाँ, तो एक टाइम में ऐसा माना जाता था कि बंगाल, अभी भी ऐसे बोलते हैं कि बंगाल इज दी हब ऑफ ब्लैक मैजिक. पहले नॉर्थ ईस्ट वगैरह में होता था, महाराष्ट्र के इंटीरियर्स में भी होता था, और बंगाल और उड़ीसा का जो कल्चर है वो समवट सिमिलर है. मतलब वहां का कुछ लैंग्वेज का भी सिमिलैरिटीज है, स्लैंग वगैरह भी मिलता है. तो ये जो किस्सा हुआ था, ये ओडिशा में हुआ था, जैसे हमारे जो ये प्रीस्ट थे इन्होंने हमें बताया था, और ये वहां पे खुद मौजूद थे. तो ओडिशा के कोई इंटीरियर्स में एकदम बहुत छोटा सा गांव है, जहाँ पे मतलब कुछ तकरीबन 300 या 350 फैमिली का ये छोटा सा ये विलेज जैसा है. एंड सिंस इट इज सो, मतलब इतना छोटा है कि ऑलमोस्ट हर फैमिली एक दूसरे फैमिली को जानता है वहां पे. तो ये केस वहां पे हुआ था कि एक जो बंदा था वो कोई तांत्रिक था, ब्लैक मैजिशियन था बेसिकली, और वो एकदम मतलब रिसेंटली वहां पे उसने मतलब शिफ्ट हुआ था और वहां पे रहने आया था. तो ऑफ लेट ये देखने को मतलब ये समझ में आया था कि फिर एवरी मतलब कुछ कुछ टाइम के बाद में हर रात को एक कोई लेडी के साथ में गलत गलत चीजें होने लग गई थी. मतलब जो फैमिलीज थे उसमें अगर कोई यंग लेडी है या अगर कोई न्यूली मैरिड है, इवन इफ द वुमन इज मैरिड, तो ऐसा सुनने आ रहा था कि द वुमन इज गेटिंग रेप्ड एंड दिस वॉज हैपनिंग एवरी नाइट और एवरी ऑल्टरनेट नाइट. और ये जब एक घर में हुआ, दो घर में हुआ, तीन घर में हुआ, देन इट स्टार्टेड यू नो रिंगिंग अलार्म इन द एंटायर विलेज की यार ऐसे ऐसे अभी एक घर में हो रहा है तो न्यूज बाकी घर में वाया वाया पहुंचने लग गया. एंड दिस स्टार्टेड हैपनिंग ऑन अ रिपीटेड बेसिस और इसका समझ में नहीं आ रहा था कि कैसे हो रहा है, क्या हो रहा है. और उसमें से कुछ एकाक वुमेन ने वहां की कोई वेल में डुबकी वगैरह लगा के किसी ने आत्महत्या कर लिया था, किसी ने सेल्फ इमोलेट कर लिया था क्योंकि बैड थिंग हैपेंड. सो इवेंचुअली एक ऐसा केस हो गया जैसा इन्होंने बताया कि एक रात को एक न्यू मतलब एक एक फैमिली में न्यूली मैरिड वुमेन आई थी, किसी के घर में नई नई शादी हुई थी. एंड दिस वॉज ओनली अ वीक और प्रोबेबली यू नो कपल ऑफ वीक्स. एंड ये जो घर था मतलब बेसिकली पूरा का पूरा घर जो था मतलब जो पूरे गांव थे दे वर वेरी मतलब हाईली बहुत मतलब भगवान को बहुत मानने वाले लोग थे और वहां पे पूजा पाठ वगैरह होता था काफी. तो ये जो लेडी थी ये रात को इसका वापस अपने आप इसका मतलब जो ये मोडस ऑपरेंडी जो ये यूज करता था जो तांत्रिक था वो रात को एकदम मिड ऑफ द नाइट में जब सब लोग सोए रोए रहेंगे तो फिर ये क्या करता था, ये वो वुमेन को या जिसके साथ में इसको कुछ गलत काम करना रहता था ये एक आध दो हफ्ते पहले से ट्रैक करने को चालू कर देता या कुछ दिनों पहले से ट्रैक करने को चालू कर देता. उसका अगर कोई चीज मिल गया, कोई आर्टिकल मिल गया, दैट वॉज हिज एम. मतलब उसका कुछ पार्ट ऑफ क्लोथ मिल गया या कुछ तो उसका बॉडी हेयर मिल गया या एनीथिंग ऑफ दैट सॉर्ट जिससे वो वुडू कर पाए, जिससे वो मतलब तंत्र विद्या वगैरह करता. और उससे वो क्या करता था रात को एकदम डेड नाइट में वो उसको तंत्र विद्या के थ्रू वशीभूत करके अपने यहाँ पे बुला लेता था, अपने घर में बुला लेता था. एंड देन यूज टू डू ऑल द बैड एक्ट्स. और फिर एंड और औरत को जिसके साथ में वो कर रहा है उसको कुछ पता ही नहीं कि क्या हुआ कैसे हुआ. शी वुड प्रोबेबली कमिट she would probably come to know about you know the mishappening later on या मतलब जब उसका नींद या उसका जब वो consciousness में आएगी she would probably find herself nude in the middle of the road or something of that sort. तो ये औरत के साथ में ऐसा हुआ कि इसको ये तांत्रिक नए नए एकदम शादी हुए थे और उसने उसको टैप वैप किया रहेगा तो ये एकदम इसका नींद मतलब ये अचानक से रात को इसके अपने इसका ये मतलब उठ गई और इसके अंदर दरवाजा वगैरह खुला. घर में सब लोग सोए हुए रहेंगे सिंस इट वाज अ प्रॉपर विलेज वहां पे कुछ शाम होने के बाद में आई थिंक 7 या 8 बजे के आसपास या 9 बजे के आसपास सब लोग सो जाते रहेंगे और वहां पे इतना कुछ लाइट्स वगैरह का भी शायद प्रबंध नहीं रहा होगा. तो ये एकदम मिड ऑफ द नाइट में उठी और इसके अंदर दरवाजा वगैरह खोला और ये मतलब ये ऑलरेडी इसके ऊपर वुडू हो चुका था और ये चलने को चालू हो गई. उसके जहाँ पे वो तांत्रिक वगैरह रहता था वहां पे इसका चालू हो गया. तो ये चल के जा रही है और ये पूरी की पूरी नूड उसने घर पे ही अपना पूरा का पूरा जो है सब कपड़ा वगैरह उतार दिया था. शी वाज कंप्लीटली वॉकिंग नूड इन द मिडल ऑफ द नाइट और जा रही है. इसके साथ में खाली उस दिन एक अच्छा जो बात हो गया वो ये हुआ कि वो जो जिस रोड से जा रही थी उस रोड में कहीं पर बीच में एक जगह शिव मंदिर पड़ता था. अब हुआ ये था कि कुछ दिन पहले कोई फेस्टिवल वगैरह था शिव जी का तो वहां पे लगातार एक दो दिन से पूजा पाठ वगैरह और काफी देर रात तक चल रहा था. तो उस दिन जब इसके साथ में ये गलत व्यवहार होने वाला था ये जब चल के जा रही थी तो मंदिर के यहाँ से पानी गिर के नीचे हो आया था और एक जगह आके इकट्ठा हो गया था, एक जगह आके कहीं पर तो एसिमिलेट हो गया था. तो ये हम लोग गेस करे किया तो शिव जी का अभिषेक वगैरह किया था या क्या किया था पता नहीं, बट वहां से मंदिर का पानी था और वहां पे आके नीचे आके एक जगह आके इकट्ठा हो गया था. अब जैसे ही ये औरत वहां से चलते जा रही है उसका पैर वो जैसे ही पानी के ऊपर पड़ा शी बिकेम कॉन्शियस. उसका वो जो था वो जिस स्टेज में थी हाँ शी स्नैप आउट ऑफ इट और उसका जैसे ही वो कॉन्शियसनेस में आई शी उसने देखा कि क्या है मतलब वो पूरी की पूरी नूड है. शी वॉज नॉट वेयरिंग एनीथिंग और वो मिडल ऑफ द रोड में इन द डेड ऑफ नाइट व्हेन देयर इज नो वन अराउंड लिटरली नो वन अराउंड. तो वो एकदम घबरा गई और वहीं से चिल्ला के वो अपने रिटर्न आने लगी मतलब अपने घर की तरफ आने. एंड शी वॉज सो स्केर्ड जब तक वो घर पे आई तब तक ऑलरेडी उसके साथ फैमिली वाले उठ गए और ये बात फिर बाकी के गांव वालों को भी बोला गया कि ऐसा ऐसा हो गया. थैंकफुली शी वॉज सेव्ड लेकिन अभी इसका हल निकालना था. तो वहां के जो गांव वाले और उनका जो मुखिया था वहां पे एक बहुत पुराना बूढ़ा तांत्रिक था एंड ही वॉज वेरी ओल्ड एंड ही वॉज वेरी वेल नोन और उसको लोग बोलते थे कि भैया ये कोई मतलब ये अपने तंत्र विद्या से लोगों को हेल्प करता है तो सम पीपल कॉल दिस एज व्हाइट मैजिक ऑल्दो आई डोंट रियली थिंक देयर इज समथिंग कॉल्ड एज व्हाइट मैजिक इन द डिक्शनरी तंत्र विद्या ही रहता है कोई उसका मिसयूज करता है या कोई उसका यूज करता है अच्छे कामों के लिए अब वो लोग ने इसको अप्रोच किया ये जो अच्छे जो साधु इंसान थे उसको अप्रोच किया और उन्होंने ऐसा ऐसा बताया ऑल्दो ही ऑलरेडी न्यू अबाउट इट लेकिन ही वॉज सच अ सेम काइंड ऑफ पर्सन की वो ही वॉज लीस्ट बॉदर्ड विद व्हाट इज हैपनिंग वो अपने ही इसमें हमेशा पड़े रहते थे अब जब इन लोगों ने इतना उनको बोला और इतना समझाया कि अभी बहुत ज्यादा होने लग गया प्लीज ट्राई एंड यू नो फाइंड अ सोल्यूशन तो उन्होंने क्या बोला कि जो गांव का जो मुखिया था गांव के मुखिया को उसने अपने पास में बुलाया कि मुझे सिर्फ यहाँ पे 3 लोग चाहिए आपके अलावा 2 और तो आपका अगर कोई बहुत ही जबरदस्त कॉन्फिडेंट है और आपका कोई एकदम कोई फैमिली मेंबर है जिसके ऊपर आप पूरे तरीके से ट्रस्ट कर सकते हो उसको आप रखो उसके साथ में उसके कोई एक एसोसिएट को रखो बाकी सब लोगों को यहाँ से जाने तो उसने बोला कि ठीक है तो वो गांव का जो मुखिया था उसने अपने कोई एक बहुत ही जिगरी दोस्त और उसके कोई एक एसोसिएट को रखा जिसके ऊपर कंप्लीटली ट्रस्ट किया जा सकता है और बाकी लोगों को बोला कि आप लोग जाइए हम लोग इनसे जो संत बाबा है उनसे बात करके फिर बताते हैं क्या है तो सब जब चले गए तो फिर इन्होंने बोला ये जो संत महात्मा थे इन्होंने बोला कि आपको मैं एक सीक्रेट काम दे रहा हूँ आपको ये अपने फैमिली मेंबर से भी नहीं बात करना अगर आपने अपने घर में किसी को भी यहाँ तक कि अपनी बीवी बच्चे या अपने हस्बैंड को किसी को भी बोला तो फिर पॉसिबली अगर ये जरा सा भी बात इधर उधर फैल गई तो वो जो तांत्रिक है जो ये सब गलत काम कर रहा है उसके काम तक चले जाएगी तो फिर ये नहीं होगा तो उन्होंने बोला कि ठीक है आप हमें बताइए हम लोग अपने तक ही रखेंगे अब भैया उसने क्या बोला कि आप जो है हर एक के घर में जाइए जितने भी यहाँ पे जो भी है जो जितने भी यहाँ पे कस्बे में रह रहे विलेज में रह रहे हर एक के घर में जाइए और हर एक के घर से ना कुछ खाने का आइटम लेके आइए पॉसिबली राइस या अगर कुछ कुछ भी मतलब एक बेसिक कुछ भी रहे अब समझ सकते कि भैया अगर कोई बहुत गरीब है तो उन्होंने बोला कि अगर किसी के पास कुछ भी नहीं है तो उनके पास एक छोटा सा ग्लास पानी लेके आ जाइए इतना आप कैसे भी करके कर दीजिए अभी उन्होंने बोला कि हम लोग पहुंचते बेसिस पे जाके मांगे क्या करें तो उन्होंने बोला कि वो आप देखिए मतलब आप कुछ भी स्टोरी कुकअप कीजिए बट ऑल आई वुड नीड इज सम ऑर द अदर ईटिंग आइटम फ्रॉम ईच एंड एवरी हाउस एन ऑफरिंग और अ गिफ्ट जिसके थ्रू मतलब जो है वो आगे का मैं देखूंगा तो इन लोगों ने हर एक घर में जाना शुरू किया और हर एक घर में इन लोगों ने बोला कि कुछ तो उन्होंने एक्सक्यूज बनाया रहेगा कि अभी वापस से कुछ तो हमें फेस्टिवल वगैरह करना है सो वी आर ट्राइंग टू यू नो एसिमिलेट फूड आइटम्स तो आप अपने घर से जो हो सकता है वो दे दीजिए तो हर एक के घर से कुछ ना कुछ जो है देने को शुरू है ये जो तांत्रिक था ये जो ब्लैक म्यूजिशियन था ये इसको कुछ तो डाउट हो गया रहेगा तो ये घर से कुछ देने को रेडी नहीं था अब उन्होंने बोला कि आप एक आधा ग्लास पानी दे दीजिए और यहीं पर सब लोगों के यहाँ मतलब आप जो भी ऑफर करोगे सब गांव वालों को यहाँ पर वापस बुला के सब लोगों में डिस्ट्रीब्यूट भी किया जाएगा तो आप घबराइए मत और क्योंकि वो गांव का मुखिया था तो फिर वो जो ब्लैक मैजिशियन था उसने इतना सोचा नहीं चलो ठीक है अब जब ये मुखिया आके बोल रहा है और मतलब इतना कोर्स करेगी नहीं ठीक है और यहाँ पर सब लोग को बुलाया भी जाएगा तो उसने फिर इतना डाउट नहीं किया उसने कुछ जो भी है घर का कुछ दे दिया शायद पॉसिबली राइस या कुछ तो दे दिया रहेगा अब इन लोगों ने हर एक घर से कुछ ना कुछ प्रोडक्ट कुछ ना कुछ फूड आइटम्स वगैरह लेके आए और इन जो संत बाबा थे इनको आके दे दिया अब उसने संत बाबा ने क्या किया उसने वो सारा का सारा जो फूड आइटम्स लिया उसका उसने प्रिपरेशन शुरू कर दिया और कुछ कुछ जगहों पर ऐसा बोला जाता है कि अगर आपको ब्लैक मैजिक को तोड़ना है कुछ एक ऐसे ब्लैक मैजिक रहते हैं जिनका कोई तोड़ नहीं है लेकिन कुछ एक लेवल के जो ब्लैक मैजिक रहते हैं उनको अगर आपको तोड़ना है तो उसके तरीके उसमें एक तरीका ये है कि जो बुलक पार्ट रहता है तो जो जिससे जो हल जो जोता जाता है जो आप गाय या बैल के पीछे लगाते हैं उसको आप फूड ऑफर करो और उसकी आरती निकालो और उसके थ्रू फिर जिसने ब्लैक मैजिक किया उसका आप आइडेंटिफाई किया जा सकता है तो अब ये क्या कैसे क्या होगा तो उन्होंने फूड आइटम्स वगैरह जो संत बाबा थे उन्होंने बनाया और वहां पर जो बुल रखा हुआ था उसके पीछे जो लट्ठा रहता है जहां पे आप जो जो चीज को बांधते हो जिससे आप फार्म को पूरा जो जोतते हो जो भी जो स्टार्ट होता है उसका थोड़ा उन्होंने कुछ पूजा वगैरह किया और उन्होंने कुछ मंत्र उच्चारण वगैरह किया रहेगा अब उन्होंने क्या बोला कि ये जो है ये जो फूड है अभी आपको डिस्ट्रीब्यूट करना पड़ेगा हर एक के घर में यू विल हैव टू एंश्योर कि हर एक जिसने भी दिया है यू विल हैव टू एंश्योर कि हर कोई खाए एक भी दाना अगर किसी ने किसी किसी भी तरीके से आपको यू विल हैव टू इंश्योर कि कोई ना कोई कुछ ना कुछ तो खाए. अब क्योंकि ये आप बोल रहे हो कि डिस्ट्रीब्यूटेड या ऑफर्ड फूड है तो आई एम श्योर कि किसी को कोई प्रॉब्लम नहीं रहेगा. ऐसे वो संत बाबा बोल रहे हैं हर कोई कुछ ना कुछ तरीके से तो खा ही लेगा. आप ऐसा अगर आप जाके बोलोगे कि ये फूड ये ऑफर्ड आइटम है प्रसाद है तो कोई मना नहीं करेगा. तो उन्होंने बोला ठीक है. तो उन्होंने क्या किया, एक जगह पूरे गांव वालों को जमा किया और उनको बोला कि ये मंदिर का फूड है, ये प्रसाद है, आपको हर एक को आके यहाँ पे ग्रहण करना. तो उन्होंने हर एक को जमा किया इंक्लूडिंग दिस ब्लैक मैजिशियन. वो आ गया और वहां पर दे एंश्योर्ड कि जितने गांव वाले थे इंक्लूडिंग अ स्मॉल बेबी जितने भी थे बूढ़े से लेकर छोटे बच्चे तक हर एक ने वो फूड को खाया. थोड़ा थोड़ा भी जो भी है वो खाना है वो खाया. अब जो संत बाबा थे उनका काम चालू हो गया. अब हाउ विल यू आइडेंटिफाई द पर्सन हु इज कमिटिंग ऑल दिस एक्ट ऑल दिस सिंपल एक्टिविटी. तो क्योंकि वो फूड जो था उसके अंदर उन्होंने कोई ना कोई तरीके से कुछ ना कुछ चैंट्स वगैरह किए थे और उसको आइडेंटिफाई करने के लिए उन्होंने क्या किया, वो जो बुलक कार्ट का जो बैक रहता है जहां से वो हल जोता जाता है वहां पर उन्होंने स्टिक से जोर जोर से मारना शुरू किया. अब जैसे ही वो स्टिक जोर जोर से मार रहे हैं बुलक कार्ट के पीछे वैसे ही वो जो ब्लैक मैजिशियन था उसके पीठ पे लगने लग गई एज इफ द पर्सन वॉज डायरेक्टली गेटिंग हिट बाय दैट स्टिक विच दिस सेंट वॉज यूजिंग. और वो वहीं पर खाना खाते खाते चिल्लाने लग गया. जैसे ही वो उन्होंने संत महात्मा ने चालू किया तो वैसे ही यहाँ पे कूदने लग गया एंड उसके यहाँ पे पीछे पूरे निशान वगैरह भी आने लग गए. एंड उसने फिर तुरंत जो संत महात्मा तो उन्होंने बोल दिया कि यही है बंदा जिसने पूरा का पूरा काम किया है. और उस बंदे को वहीं पर पूरे के पूरे गांव वालों ने मिलके वहां पर उसको मार ही दिया. इतना मारे मतलब भाला वगैरह लेके उसको वहीं पर
नहीं सुरेश ये स्टोरी शुरू हुआ था सन 1910 में. ब्रो वेरी स्कैरी स्टोरी. नाइस.
कब हुआ था बट क्योंकि ये सेंट ने हम लोग को बोला सो वी आर एक्सपेक्टिंग ये रियल स्टोरी है. ठीक है. तो इसका कंक्लूजन ये हुआ कि उसको वो गांव वाले थे एंड देवर मतलब इतना गलत काम हो गया था उनके लेडीज के साथ में कि इट इज वेरी यू नो डिफिकल्ट टू होल्ड देम बैक. उनका वैसे ही इतना दिमाग खराब हुआ रहेगा कि दे मस्ट हैव मतलब उन्होंने सामने.
So yeah, imagine, yeah, yeah. imagine today's world, they'll tell Zomato सबके घर से खाना लेके आना.
Man, freaky story. Thank you, Rohan. Thanks for sharing.
Long one.
Thank you so much.
काफी लंबा story था.
Actually, this story should have been narrated by अपना विश्वनाथन. Should have been faster.
इसकी पूछ. Rohan, ये बहुत लंबी कहानी थी.
But this could be converted into like a film script also or like a television show. Bro, hardcore.
A series.
Thank you, Rohan. Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Thank you, bhai. Thank you so much, bhai.
Thank you, Rohan.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Oh, Baba.
Cyril, your mic is off, by the way.
Yeah, which is not a bad thing.
Cyril, get on. No, we just wanted to keep it off.
Keep it off. I just want to say that, was that the shorter of the two stories Rohan wanted to tell us?
Bro, somebody, I got...
somebody was saying, imagine him telling two stories.
Yeah.
But it was fast, clear and precise.
Look I just want
to
say,
people thought I died on this screen.
You see Cyrus's face. You got rid of the mirror. Why are you freaking messing with us like this?
I didn't get rid of the mirror. But
listen, what? No, I just want to take this, like Cyril said, I want to take this opportunity. Fuck you, Cyrus.
What?
Stop screwing on you guys. I want to take this opportunity to say that there'll be lots of different kinds of stories, yeah. And we appreciate all of them. Some are long, some stories people are enjoying that we are maybe finding boring. We are enjoying stories that maybe other people are finding boring. Just enjoy the stream till we're done. After that, you all can sit and discuss it.
Also, it's beautiful, bro. People come share their stories. Yeah. It's really lovely. Someone has freaked me the fuck out because they sent me a photograph of a face in the mirror. Bro, aise na gand dravni cheeze mat kiya karo.
They photoshopped a face in the picture in the mirror and sent it to you.
No, anyway, I'm telling you.
Vishnu Narayanan has sent me a picture and he's put up there's a face in the mirror, bro. He's saying there's a face in the mirror. Yeah, and I'm looking at the mirror right now and there's nothing.
Yeah. Anyway, you guys, one sec. Mithu Chaudhary yeah. says 1.3 people who haven't liked the stream yet. Please, yes, thank you, Mithu, for reminding us. Please go and do that. Show some appreciation of super entertainment from these fine Bandra lads, the lone Andheri man.
Lone?
Which one of y'all is from Andheri? All right. I'm just kidding. Vijay says, guys, please let me in. My story won't disappoint. Let me in.
Whoa, let him in, bro. We need a horrifying story, like something that grips you.
I'm fairly horrified by all this.
Not horrifying from a lens perspective, but mostly from hitting the soul kind of perspective.
Priti Shok, Riya Roy, Rohan Tiwari, Rohan Nagya, Nitish Ratnani.
I kind of ate dinner.
See, sometimes I don't mind the stories going long because I'm waiting for that end, some crazy end.
Yeah, but then I start losing the chain of the whole village.
That's what we are looking.
Bro, in his previous story, the end was that the whole village killed that.
You have to look at Jose's face. Yeah. You know when it's going too long, he starts to twitch a little bit. Yeah. Mm. You know that
Jose spasms, na?
Yeah.
Yeah, his head starts jerking and shit.
I am honest, so I keep myself on camera. Cyril, turn this off, and then Cyril, this is Cyril, okay? After the long story happening, suddenly he's disappeared. And when he comes back,
yeah, he's chewing. And you know, Cyril, I skipped dinner for the stream, and I'm starving. I'm feeling really hungry. I'm just chewing.
Go get your food. Vijay, you're on.
We can eat.
Yeah. I've got a feeling Vijay's story is going to get me, man. Vijay, is this gripping?
Yeah.
First of all, Vijay, you need to put that glass down.
Cheers.
It's ridiculous
cheers,
to be
Vijay,
like this.
Cheers.
Yeah. Cheers,
bro.
Cheers. Right. Yeah. Cheers again. Okay. All right, Vijay, enough.
Vijay is doing the make it look like a picture challenge. Yeah. Vijay, are you there?
Yeah.
Can I go ahead with the story?
Yes, you can.
Oh, sorry, Vijay.
Tum log band karoge bhi?
Vijay, first tell me, has this story haunted you for a while?
It's haunting me right now.
Oh my God, this sounding okay, real serious.
All right, go for it.
A love problem also. Go for it.
This is a two-parter story. Okay. So both of them are important. That's why I have to say but it's very small.
Okay. Don't worry. No one will judge you. Everyone, some people have small, some people have... Don't worry.
Yeah. Size doesn't matter.
Yeah.
Okay.
So what do you do with this story?
Yeah. The first one is when I was, I think, about 4 or 5. So my cousin brother, he used to work at a tea state. So in the, like, Sundays and all, we used to go to his bungalow to just chill. And since, like, I was not interested in, like, chatting with my brother and all because he is, like, really older than me. So my parents used to go to his place and like chill out. And I used to hang out in the garden, right? And in the garden, they had a swing. It was a really large swing. And because I was like really tiny then, I could not like, you know, I needed a little help sitting on the swing. So anyways, like I got in the swing and then I started swinging. And I was hearing my mother like, talking in the distance, right? And so as I was swinging, like as I said, like I was not that tall back then, so I could not swing a lot. So as I was swinging, I felt that suddenly my swing is, you know, taking speed. It's becoming faster by itself. Then suddenly I felt like someone was holding the paddle, you know, and I was like, I was so paralyzed with fear that I did not want to look back because I know if I look back, something bad will happen.
Yeah.
So I was so scared to look back and it started swinging really hard. And then suddenly when I decided like I would jump right now, right?
Yeah.
And what happened was I felt little tiny hands behind me and it was really cold, almost wet. And that was the time I just jumped. I skinned my knees, I ran to my mom, but I didn't tell her anything. Okay, that was the first part of the story.
Mm.
Second part of the story is right before the virus outbreak began, it was in November 2019, yes. November 2019, I and my girlfriend had gone to Calcutta. So we had nothing much to do. So we went to Eco Park. So if you guys know what Eco Park is, it's actually very like big park, and it has a large lake and lots of tiny, tiny lakes around it, right? So we took a boat ride, and it was like, I think five, but because it was winter, so it had been dark by then. So we were taking a boat ride, and I think it was like 15 minutes of ride. Then we came back to the shore, and then we were walking around in the park, right? And everywhere we went, like we like found benches and all, and we are sitting down. And suddenly we hear this announcement, right? In the loudspeakers and all.
Right.
But we could not make out what that person was saying, because it was not clear, you know, it was very fuzzy. So 2 hours, then we went back. Next day morning, what happened was, we just sat down for our breakfast and we read the news. And the news was, a four-year-old boy had drowned in one of the lakes.
Oh, man. Oh, man. At the eco park.
Yes. And what is the most horrifying thing is, as I was reading the news, I don't know why the first story, it was running in the back of my mind. So...
shit.
Yeah.
What I think was happened was like, maybe it was like a premonition. I'm not sure. Like,
Yeah, the coincidence was crazy.
Yeah. And just the way that boy died, right? Mm. What happened was, see, there are these small lakes that had like, you know, shrubs and all those plants.
Yeah.
And it had outgrown so much. Now it looks like land. You cannot think out if it is a lake or a land. So that kid had fallen inside that. And even if he wanted to come out of the water, the shrub would not let him.
Right.
And I think I saw something move when I was sitting in one of the benches. And I'm not sure. I saw something move.
Wow. And it was a long time ago also. So
yeah.
And it was a wet hand.
Yeah.
So it was basically like it was still in water.
Oh, I missed that.
Yeah. Yeah, that's right. He said that in the beginning. The coincidences were pretty tight at the end of
it. But maybe it was trying to reach out to you, bro.
Yeah, exactly.
I think also it is what you experienced as a child was as a child, and this thing happened when you're an adult.
Yes.
Not necessarily there should be any link between them. What happened to this child is absolutely scary and very sad. But I feel you should, that dream, that feeling that you had, the experience that you went through is your own.
Yes.
Maybe something like that happened close by where you were in that park swing.
Yes.
So these two are unrelated.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. I think this, Vijay, what you need to be, because you said this is still affecting you, is that I think you need to let go of this aspect of it and just have positive thoughts towards, you know, putting it out there, you know, and it could be in any form. It could be in this, like putting, you know, a good thought in your head and wishing the best for everything that's out there. Right. So I understand that, like Suresh said, there are two parts of this. Part one was when you were, you know, much younger, and then part two was more recent. And it seems like, you know, it's looping,
interconnected.
Try not to do that, because unless, when you do go through experiences, you tend to feel like that. When you go through, especially experiencing the four-year-old, it'll tend to make you feel like these things are connected to each other.
Yeah.
Unless he's feeling... Sorry. Unless Vijay is feeling that when he sat on one of the benches, he perhaps saw something move in the shrubs, and it could have been the child trying to free himself.
Exactly.
Yeah.
That is what is running in your mind. So
yeah.
Yeah. Maybe, I don't want to, you're right. You know, maybe it's not a paranoid thought. Maybe they are interconnected and stuff like that. But I think saying a prayer and peacefully praying that whatever it is gets its peace and moves on, you know, is a good thing for you, man. Because what happens to the mind is otherwise it starts playing with you.
Playing,
you know what
tricks
I mean?
On you.
You start playing tricks on you. You start looking at other things and start thinking there's a pattern or a message to it. And that stuff can get you very paranoid, Vijay. You know?
Yeah.
So just
Vijay, thanks for sharing with us. Bugging you, if it's really bothering you, you should find someone close to speak with, maybe even check out therapy.
Yeah.
Right?
No, yeah.
That's why you guys help me a lot, right?
Yeah.
Scary story.
Think positive and, you know, I'd say give it love. Give it like some positive energy and love and hope that...
Give yourself also a big hug.
Yeah, man.
Thank you all.
Thank you, Vijay.
You'll be fine, bro.
Take care,
cheers.
Vijay.
Cheers, Vijay. Cheers.
Cheers, my brother. Cheers. Jambo.
Hoezaay, sir. I need to read out a message which is like written in anger from this guy.
In anger? So how do you
then don't read it then. Okay. Yeah.
Capital. I paid super chats a lot. Guys, please let me in. Suresh, I hope I'm next. Sir, please tell Hoezaay to let me in. It's not a long story, but quite scary. Please ask Hoezaay to let me in.
All maybe he's not saying it like that. No, he must be saying it. There were caps button stuck. Over. But I'm saying this part just now. No, there was an intersection of ghost stories and love advice there. I don't know if you guys noticed.
Yeah.
Immediately, all were like, let me try to help this guy. That's so sweet.
Yeah. But can I tell you the first part of the story when he started talking about before I heard the second part? The first
the
part,
little
I
boy. Ask,
yeah, no. The little boy was the second part.
The river. The
first part where he was on the swing and he felt small, wet hands. I was going to tell him that Suresh normally does hang around in parks sometimes.
Yes.
And he tends to sneak up behind
him. He wets his hands and then he goes and pushes people on swings.
A lot of people think Suresh wets his hand, but he has nervous hands. Yeah. They're always sweating. There's a condition where he sweats only from his hands.
Suresh, who was that who sent you the message?
Pritesh Oak.
Even Ria Roy is saying that I have a really gripping story.
Yeah, Ria Roy.
Yeah. I'm trying to get into the stream.
My dad has got a story. Also sent a message saying that she's...
I just... my someone from my family called a very gripping story. I put the phone down.
Hey, this is Ratnani.
No, this is
This lake story was nice because it was kind of like sad and unnerving, and maybe the spirits have not made peace with this stuff.
You know, when you experience these scenarios, it really pays. Like going to a morgue, and
I saw a little baby in a morgue.
Live long and be prosper. Yeah. Please save me from this conversation, sir. you seen babies in the morgue?
Yes, who is it? Nitesh Ratnani?
Yes, that's me.
Is that a real background?
Are you the dad?
Where's the dad?
You're the son.
Oh, there's dad. Yeah,
good evening, uncle. How's it going?
Sir, how are you?
It's going great. How are you?
Very good, uncle. Just push him away and you take over the screen. Don't worry. I'm just joking. Hey, aap log saath mein come together. I was just joking. Tum log saath mein.
Yeah, okay. Let me tell you, Nitesh is a good, means a great fan of you guys.
Thank you, sir.
I'm a great fan of Hoezaay, but unfortunately, I'm not a fan of other three guys. Sorry about
that. We'll try hard.
Sir. Okay. Uncle, all this means is that you haven't seen some of my videos yet.
basically, the other three guys, what they do, I don't understand much. So that's why.
Correct. Even I don't. So
even we don't. We are all in the same boat.
Uncle, join the gang.
Who knows? Anyway, Uncle, go for it. Take it away. The stage is yours.
Yeah. Thanks. Thanks for giving us an opportunity. And this is a real scary stuff. So you guys better hold on to your chairs. You know, I don't want any of you to get invisible. So this is about, you know, I was something about 8-10 years back when I was working with a call center, and this experience was one of my colleagues, and he just told me this. Since he was working at a call center, the timings of work are sometimes you go back late night, you know, and you catch the midnight trains. And this guy, he was staying at Virar. And, you know, Virar is a last suburb at the Western Railway. Okay. So it so happened that usually he used to try after midnight. And once he catches the train, as the train proceeds towards the last station, the train goes on getting empty. Right. And so this was one such day. And it was around Borivali station wherein the train almost got empty. In fact, it got empty and everybody got down. That's when the train started. A girl, you know, just caught the train in a running condition and got into the train. There was no one else in the compartment. This boy sitting on at one end, and this girl caught a seat at the other end of the compartment. Okay. Now the train starts, and you know, at nighttime, the speed of the train is also quite high. You know, it run very fast, and the noise of the tracks, you know, that okay. This girl was sitting at the other end of the compartment, boy at this end. The girl was with the back towards this boy. Okay. nothing unusual. Now the train speeds, and it's just on the midway to the next next station, right? So this boy suddenly starts hearing some beeping sounds, and you know, he was a little scared. Then suddenly the girl gets up, screams, and you know, gives a big shriek, runs towards the door, and just jumps out of the door. Oh my God, this boy, it's just a spine, I mean, chill runs down his spine, you know. And he's shivering in his pants, and he doesn't know what to do. He gathers himself up, goes to the door, and by that time, I mean, it's quite far off, and he couldn't see anything. And he's damn scared, and he's waiting for the next station to come. As soon as the station comes, he gets around the station, rushes straight to the station master's cabin. And, you know, he's so frightened. He tells them, come on, sir, one of the girls got into the compartment. She was weeping, and then she just jumped out of the train. You please get up. Come on, get the ambulance. Let's go and find her body. The station master is unmoved. This boy gets a little wily. He shakes the station master. Come on, gentlemen, get up. So the station master slowly gets up, puts a pat on the shoulder, makes him sit on the chair, gives him a glass of water, tells him, gentlemen, you see, we have heard this story for a number of times. And, you know, we have actually gone and checked, oof, and we have never found anything. So all I would suggest is just forget and just go home. And then by that time, 2-3 more people got collected, and they were just mentioning, oh, same story. And one of them just mentioned that there was some girl who had committed this suicide. And I don't know if it's related to that.
My God. Oh, wow. Uncle, you have that given us multiple habubus.
Yeah,
we are all habibing over here.
Thank you. Never traveling by train ever again.
Boys, this was towards Virar, correct?
How do you deal with seeing something like that, though?
How do you deal with seeing something like
that? It's traumatic. Exactly. Yeah.
This
is very traumatic.
That stuff can wreck you. How unnerving. What's your theory on it, Uncle? You think that people, like, she's lost in a loop, like she was constantly doing that over and over again? Why do you think, like, even if they are spirits, we say we are spirits, then this happens. Why do you think it happens?
Well, in that same call center, a number of people, others also said, yes, they have heard this type of a story. So, unless you come across it, you can't believe it.
Yeah.
Maybe her station had come and she missed it. Anyway, let's not get into all that.
Yeah. Jose, remember
the story.
Uncle, thank you so much for sharing that story with us.
Thank you.
Happy Father's Day in advance for tomorrow.
Hey, so happy Father's Day.
Harami chat mentioned, said to tell you that.
And I promise you, Uncle, the three of us will do better.
Yeah, we'll try. We'll try, Uncle, hopefully next time.
Okay, nice.
All right, guys, have a good night. Thank you so much for being on our stream. Wow.
I just want to take this opportunity to say that was the smoothest roast of the three of us I've ever seen.
Exactly.
Honestly, how much did you pay?
But
that's
actually
a relative of mine. I'm just kidding.
I know we don't have a psychology stream, but I must say that our self-esteem is in the gutter because there was no defense.
I was going to log out.
I can understand.
We just moved in. Anyway, while Uncle said this story,
I saw Jose's smile go from the ear.
Dude, I saw replay this footage where Jose looked like a Cheshire cat.
I'm just happy that my audience varies from the 4-year-old.
Yeah.
You know, at one point when Cyrus said, "Uncle, what's your take on it?" I thought it would have been funny if Suresh started answering.
I almost did, but
for Uncle who's still watching the stream, hopefully currently right now, Uncle, I want to tell you that these three people, I was thinking about this while you were telling the story, these three people are amazing. And let me tell you about their
That is more humiliating. Married. 1 minute. That is more humiliating.
Can I tell you?
Let me finish.
One second. Let me break this.
I was going to say there's no achievements.
Can I tell you when Jose Saki, his accent comes out? He's like, let me tell you about
Uncle, let me tell you a little bit about my audience. You know, I'm an international star.
What would be funny if Uncle said, Shakib, great job.
Yeah. Uncle thinking
of Shakib? Sadly, son has said, I know son's ID, so I'm going to just spam him tomorrow with a lot of my showreels and all
So I'm sure Uncle is a connoisseur of content, so to speak. He's watching my stuff. God knows what else he's watching. But Uncle, just so you know, these are the things you have to look up. For Suresh Menon, You have to go. Just type his name in Google.
Dude, do not.
Type Suresh Menon, Sunny Leone, and you'll get the discography of the best films. Cyrus Sahukar. Type Semi Girebal in the Google search.
No, please watch something recent. This is me shitting on you, Jose.
Just type Semi Girebal, uncle, and then Cyril.
I don't do any content. I'm just here as an administrator. I have absolutely nothing.
For Cyril, you have to go to his Instagram account to see what he does there.
No, no.
Anyway.
I think the dog is moving.
Thank you, uncle. What entertainment.
Hey, I'm Atma.
You know, but Jose, it is on behalf of the three of us, we have to take it's remarkable that you have such esteemed like age group of people, you know, watching your content.
I'm just worried about when uncle finds out about my other videos, then he'll be like, what the hell was I doing? But anyway,
I want to tell a story.
But yo, this thing of imagine you're alone in a train and a girl comes in and
that shit would wreck
and creepy.
Jumps out that and how shit. Do you deal with that till the
can
next
I, can
station?
I ask you the question? The first thing that came to my head was, do you think that this spirit is looping to the point that it invokes you to try and jump out after her?
Oh my.
But he didn't try to jump. No one was going to do that.
No, some people will. If you think you're going to try and save somebody.
Yeah.
And you might be jumping into your.
Or the other explanation. Yes, sir. Finger up. Yes.
Just so that people, if they ever face something like that, don't try to jump off the train there's a chain, you can pull it, stop the train, and you know the guard comes, and then you can tell exactly what happened if it really happens in real life. So
I will scream and hold the chair very tight.
No one should ever jump from a train, and no one should ever do that. The concept was to do you think that's what the spirit is trying to invoke?
I
didn't say anything. Suresh is taken out of context.
Do you think there could be a love story? What about a love story? You meet this girl on a train, you have a beautiful conversation, and then you just realize it was a spirit. Huh?
I mean, she's crying. So actually, there's something to it, right? He said.
So
I got confused
where uncle said, you know, that 7-8 years back, but he was working. So was he in the train? And there was a young boy.
Mm. Oh, friend. He said uncle's friend.
Yeah,
he said and spoke of that person in the third person.
It's not happened to me. Yeah, because I saw his eyes while he was telling the story. This story didn't happen to him. This story, if it happened to you, man, this would shake you up.
He didn't believe the story, by the way, because when Cyrus got into the uncle, can you tell me if you believe in this? Uncle's like,
what I loved is uncle didn't get what I said.
Bokashi sends me a video of me and Cyrus ka short leke. She has put a finger on her lipstick.
Somebody said spirit zoned. Prasad.
Oh, spirit zoned.
Look, I have another explanation. We should move to the next call. But another explanation is that there is a girl somewhere who enjoys playing these pranks on someone, and she's some kind of stunt person like X Games.
Oh,
so she's scaring
X Games? Dude, doing it for decades? That's scary. Now, Suresh, this is where we say, don't ever do anything like this.
Of course not.
Yeah. Suresh loves this dog, no?
Real quick, Hari Nair says, I love Suresh, Cyril and Cyrus. I don't like Jose. The balance of this universe has been restored.
Okay. Hari, you have great choice of content. And
Cyrus has come back fully charged from work today. He's gone completely.
Uncle got us.
What's Rajesh?
Rajesh, a very nice name for a dog.
Hey, British dog. Hello, love. We'll tell a bit of a horror story about humans, yeah?
But Cyrus, I want to ask you, why are you constantly hunching like this?
This is how I live at home.
Staying
a dump on life all the time.
3,215 viewers. Thank you so much for being here. We are about 15 minutes away from ending this stream.
12.
I want to say a big thank you to my esteemed panelists who always talking.
Stop it. Not a problem. Just stop it. But no, go ahead. Say it one more time.
I put links to all their social media in case you don't know who they are. So you can go to their site.
Fuck this, bro.
You know, Jose, please stop saying semi-gribal. Semi-gribal is like decades ago. I've done a lot of work.
But I have to say, Cyrus, I did have a crush on you. When
I just wanted to experience. Maybe he would have liked it. I've kind of assumed he would like that content. But otherwise, you can always go to Cyrus's Instagram.
Here's the thing. If he wasn't the age he was at, he was a younger guy and he said that,
do you think you guys would have charged him? I don't know who you all are. Like, one second, hold on, kid.
Yeah.
Huh?
Man.
Meanwhile, crazy. Unbelievable game by Germany right now.
Yeah.
Unbelievable.
Yeah. Why are you looking like this young little 60s starlet, Suresh, with this fringe?
Yeah, he's got that front thing happening. Yeah, there.
Look at that. Aja.
Evita, you're on the stream.
Evita Rosario.
Oh, Evita's got a story. I can tell.
Evita Rosario.
Evita.
I know you've got it.
I will come live on my own YouTube channel in case chat with
we'll come in as calls.
I missed what I'm so sorry. What happened?
Pritish Shok ko main bol raha hu ki Pritish main khud live aata hu mere channel pe mujhe super chat bhejna ho se ke sath nahi
are there's nobody here call
lamba line de rahega sirf do log.
Okay, freaky RA colony story dhuli.
Oh yeah. Yes.
Oh, RA colony to 100% I would have seen the ghost.
Pritish, you made it first. Go
for it. Arnold Schwarzenegger.
Duli. Pritesh, we'll pull you back in. Duli made it first. Duli.
Yeah.
Duli pan pochli nahi. Zala kai?
Yes. Bola re bau.
Evita gave us blank call. She's like, main ja rahi hu, mere ko baat nahi karni. Okay, go for it. Come with me. Tell me a story if you want to live.
Go ahead. We have your hands.
Okay. Am I audible?
You are very Spotify.
Okay. So this is a real story.
You don't encourage these kind of jokes, Suresh.
Suresh, what is happening to you? You're laughing at this
terrible joke, and I'm upset that you're laughing at it.
I have a theory. We'll discuss this later.
This guy's gonna think he's funny, and then he's gonna go out into the world.
Oh yeah, then uncle will again come and praise him.
Exactly. Yeah. I'm seeing a pattern in this age group. This is what I'm seeing.
Duli, please save me.
Sorry.
But tell us the story. Tell me the story.
Go ahead, Duli.
Okay, I'll just get to the story directly. Okay. So this is a real life story. It happened in 2015. I am a 3D animator and I was working at an animation studio that is inside RA Mint Colony. I don't want to take the name of the studio, but it is at Mayur Nagar.
Yeah.
If you have heard of it. Mm-hmm. And there are many spooky stories about the place. And apart from how beautiful RA is, there is a very spooky vibe about it.
There is for sure. God bless you, Suresh.
So at the studios, the workload is sometimes high. And to cope with it, we have to work in shifts. Mm. The first shift is from 7 a.m. to 3 p.m. And the second shift is from 3 p.m. to 11 p.m. So there is a last bus from Mayur Nagar. It leaves at 11:30 p.m. around that time. So all of us have to catch that bus or we have to spend the night at the studio. And the studio itself kind of has some spooky stories attached to it. So we all try to make sure we caught that bus every day. So for the uninitiated and those who haven't heard of RA Mint Colony, it is basically a jungle that has been inhabited and encroached by humans. So there are wild animal sightings in the open sometimes. And the chances of encountering one is rare, but it does happen. And even we have seen like some leopard kind of a figure at night, like just before we were about to leave them. So that was basically the setup for the story. One day while having dinner in the canteen at around 8:30-ish p.m., one guy just randomly said that while going home on his bike after the second shift, he had seen a weird ghostly looking man in the middle of the road near the Chota Kashmir garden. So there is a pond and couples go there for boating and there's a kiddish park over there. So he said he saw an old man in the middle of the road near the garden sitting on a chair and reading a newspaper. And he was really unnerving. And another guy said that even he had seen an old man like that we thought that these guys were like fucking with us and trying to scare us, because that place, the jungle at night, is really, really creepy. Sometimes a friend in our group, let's call him Rohan, he would get his car to the studio and we would all go to Goregaon station with him instead of taking the bus, because car is like hopefully more secure. And we didn't want to miss the bus also. So in my head, I would be secretly wishing that I hope aaj wo gaadi laya hoga, so we can just go with him in the car. And what happened then was, a couple weeks later, Rohan, he had got his car and we left at 11 p.m. from work, from Mayur Nagar. And we were passing by the Chota Kashmir Park and Rohan suddenly stopped the car. And he said that he saw someone in the rear view mirror sitting on a chair in the middle of the road. And we were pretty freaked, but we were like, okay, let's just see. And we turned our heads around and all four of us in the car, we could see someone in the middle of the road actually reading a newspaper. At the back of our heads, I think we all knew what was happening. And we came out of the car to get a better look at what we thought was a real fucking ghost. We were looking at the old man, and he was wearing a white ganji and a blue knicker, and like I could even see his nada, and like it was that clear. And all of a sudden he turned his head to look towards us, and we noticed that the other side of his face had quite a lot of injury and blood oozing out of it. And then he stood up and started walking towards us. Like, hum log chappi gaan ekdam phad gaye. Sorry for the words, but
That's a French term.
It's the French term for it.
Yeah. And as soon as he started walking, we heard Rohan cry out. And we turned towards where he was standing and he was missing. We looked around and found him lying on the side of the road in pain. We looked up at the old man and we could not find him. We kind of had vanished or something. We lifted Rohan and drove the fuck out of RML colony and dropped him at his place at Andheri, and we went back to our respective homes. None of us were able to speak at night and we were all spooked. And we talked to Rohan next morning and he said that he felt like someone had pushed him really hard. But he didn't have any bruises or injuries, but he was just sore and he had kind of a fever or something. So the three of us, the other three of us, we met up and we went to Rohan's place to meet him and just to be there for each other, because none of us were really sure what happened and we kind of were in shock. So we reached Rohan's place, and in his room, we tried to discuss the event. And very reluctantly, he narrated an incident that happened to him a few months ago on his second day of joining the job.
Okay.
And he said that he was going home in his car after the second shift. And we hadn't become friends back then, so we didn't go in his car. And he said he had bumped into an old man around that area, the Chota Kashmir Park. And it felt like he was crossing the road, and upon impact with his car, he had fallen onto the side of the road. And fearing police introspection, he tried to speed up and leave before anyone else saw him in that place. So in his mind, he's like, maybe I killed this man or something. But and while driving towards the exit of RA, he decided that what he was doing was probably wrong and that he should go back and offer help to the old man, because he didn't want to live with a heavy conscience or guilt for the rest of his life. So he made a U-turn and he reached that place, but he found no one fallen on the road in that place where he bumped into that old man. So he started looking around and he had chills running up his spine because he could hear twigs breaking in the bush, in the trees next to the road, as if someone was walking over there. Maybe it was the old man or a leopard or something else. We don't know. And suddenly from behind him, he could hear footsteps. And Rohan turned around and he saw a man with a flashlight walking by, wearing a watchman's costume. He was probably the guard of the park or something. Rohan asked him if he had seen an injured old man around the place. The first question that the watchman asked him was, "Kaun sa budda wo akbar wala?" Then Rohan froze. Oof. Rohan froze and said, "Haan, uske haath mein kuch paper to tha," because that's how he recalled something.
Right.
And the watchman said, "Tum usko bhul jao, tum jaldi se ghar chale jao." So Rohan is like, "What? Why? What happened? Like, this explain, because my heart is going to explode." So he said, "Wo buddha aisa karta hai kabhi kabhi." And the watchman said that ye place mein uska kuch bhoot ya kuch dikhta hai kabhi kabhi logo ko, koi usko thop ke maar diya tha ek bar, abhi uska atma idhar ghumta hai, mere ko bhi dikhta hai kabhi kabhi raat ko, lekin humko dar nahi lagta, hamara gaon mein aisa bahut hota hai." And after that, Rohan just took a turn and he fucked off from that place. And as soon as he completed narrating this incident, the fucking light went off in his home and all of us started screaming like maniacs. And the door in his room opened and a yellow face appeared, but it was his mom with a lit candle in her hand. And that fucked us up even more.
Like, thank you for adding the humor part also at the end. Thank you. So that we didn't have to. Thank you. That's very kind. Buddy, wild story. Very creepy. When he
that
said,
I've
never been more scared of somebody saying, "Kaun sa buddha? Wo akbar wala?"
That was really unnerving, man. That was freaky.
Wow, bro.
Because
RMA sightings are like quite bizarre.
Yeah. There's a lot of history there, man. There's a lot of old history there. It used to, some people also believe earlier on it was a dumping ground for dead bodies when they had, you know, older part of Bombay.
Yeah.
And all these deals used to go on in Mud Island and all these places.
Yeah.
Apparently, there's a lot of old history there at a time when Mumbai just pretty much shut off from, you know, town onwards. These were all the marshy lands where there was a lot of strange history. That was a very freaky story, man.
Dhuli, thank you so much. Have thank a good you, night, buddy.
Thanks for having me, guys.
Cheers, thank cheers. You. It was take beautifully care. Narrated also.
Yeah.
Thank you.
And Priti Shok.
Not many people know, but when Dhuli's very happy also, he speaks exactly like that.
Yeah.
He's happy.
You know, I couldn't
gauge his emotion.
I've never met anybody who has the most appropriate Terminator picture.
Yeah.
He's like, perfect. That's I thought it's the Terminator one. Yeah.
I think that's
bit my arm off. Yes, that's freaky shit, man.
For me, my favorite part is that anyone can tell a story here, but only Cyrus can add credibility to that story by adding a little bit of the, you know, the history behind it.
It's a dumping
that
ground
is
for
priceless. Priceless. That
Mr.
part.
Kamath is here.
Yeah. Hey, he's taking a picture of us. Everybody pose.
Oh, enough, bro.
Yeah, man. The camera looks a little loud.
Sanjeev, haath jod ke binti karta hun ki Priti Shok aur Rear Roy.
People kept shouting, Sanjeet. Hello, who's speaking?
Can Sanjeet. I ask you a question? Yes, what if Sanjeet. I'm a really nice person and I'm a ghost? So am I going to be a nice ghost? Like, does it mean...
No.
If I'm an asshole ghost. My whole... No, supposing I've been an asshole my whole life, does that mean that I'm going to be an evil ghost? Like, does my personality transfer in my spirit form?
So let me
quote from some scientific stuff, like Ghost Part 1, the one with the Patrick Swayze. There's only one part, sorry. He's an okay guy. There's that asshole guy also, remember?
Yeah.
Who can
kick
stuff. No, anyway, let's get back to Sanjeet is on hold. Sanjeet, go for it.
Can you hear me?
We can hear you.
Okay, I'll get straight to my story. I'll
love you for that.
Formalities for the end, just in case. Super.
We'll disconnect you before you start that. Don't worry. Go for it, Sanjeet.
So, it's a personal story. So sorry if I digress a bit.
No worries.
Okay, so we had moved out to Mira Road a lot of years back because we were getting a bigger house, and the builder was a friend of my dad. So he had, just before he bought the house, he told this to my dad. There are three incidents in this story, but if you like, if the first incident you agar aapko acha lage, I'll move on to the next one.
Theek hai.
Okay, so before we bought the house, he told this to my dad only, that one of the buildings in the society is directly made on a cemetery, and all the others are made on ek aise daldal pe bana hua hai. Lekin tabhi ke time pe Mira Road was notorious for this, ki kuch bhi contract killing ya kuch hota hai ya kuch bhi aisa political murders hote, to the bodies were dumped here.
Right.
It was notorious for that.
Okay.
And he told my dad this, but he didn't tell us this. He didn't like that. Dad ne hum logo ko nahi bataya tha. And we moved in here. It's a good house, it's a big house, bigger than our previous house. We move in here, and because it is so big, we also get in our grandparents in. Nana nani ko bhi deke aa jate hain hum log yahan pe. Because they were not living with us previously. Mm-hmm.
So at this point, how many people are in your house?
Six.
Yes, six of you. Okay.
Three of us and Nana nani and Nana ke bhai bhi se, but he was a bachelor all his life.
So wo bhi saath the?
Haan, haan, hum sab saath mein rehte.
So it's a cozy home. Okay.
Yeah. And everyone has their own room. But since I was young, I was used to sleep with my parents.
Right.
Okay. So this happened. And imagine all the three grandparents, wo log kafi katte hai, fit hai. ठीक है, ऐसे एकदम कुछ ऐसे उनको कुछ प्रॉब्लम नहीं है, वॉक पे जाते थे, सब फिट है, सब खाते वगैरह वगैरह. सो द व्हेन वी मूव्ड आउट हियर विद इन टू इयर्स माय नाना उनकी तबीयत अचानक से खराब हो जाती है. लाइक टू गिव यू अ रेफरेंस, ही वो शरद पवार जैसे दिखते थे, बट बाय द टाइम उनकी हालत बहुत खराब हुई, ही इज जस्ट लाइक अ वेरी स्किनी पर्सन, अ वेरी वेरी थिन, वेरी, ही कांट ईट एनीथिंग, ही कांट फॉर्म वर्ड्स, ही कांट फॉर्म सेंटेंस, ही जस्ट कैनॉट टॉक. He's just bedridden. Okay.
And this happened how long into you moving into this house?
2 years.
2 years.
2 years. So this happened. Ek context de diya hai ki the society is built on sort of a cemetery and all the others are made on daldal, jahan pe political bodies wagera mili hai.
Daldal.
There's one building jiska construction band ho gaya tha because wahan pe aise gumnam laashe mili thi. To wo band ho gaya, uska case chal raha wagera wagera. The other context is किसने मेंशन किया था कि देवगण और राक्षसगण वगैरह होते हैं. देवगण इज बेसिकली जस्ट, इट्स जस्ट एन ऑरा. माय मॉम इज अ देवगण, सो द स्पिरिट कैन नॉट हार्म हर टेक्निकली.
आई एम अ देवगण.
ओके, सो द स्पिरिट कैन नॉट हार्म यू, कैन नॉट इवन सी द स्पिरिट, सो टू से. बट माय डैड एंड आई वी आर राक्षसगण, सो वी माइट नॉट बी एबल टू सी इट, बट इट कैन सॉर्ट ऑफ हार्म अस और व्हाटएवर. एंड एक होता है मनुष्यगण जो डायरेक्ट पोजेस हो सकता है, इट्स मान्यता है, ऐसी बिलीफ है. तो टू इयर्स, ओके, कमिंग बैक टू द नाना, बहुत उनकी हालत खराब हो गई. इवेंचुअली ही पास्ड अवे. हट्टा कट्टा आदमी ये हो गया. एंड ही व्हेन वी केम हियर, इवन व्हेन ही यूज्ड टू लिव एट हिज ओन प्लेस, ही हैड दिस चेयर. ठीक है, इट वॉज हिज चेयर. एक ऐसा फोल्डिंग कुर्सी होता है ना, फोल्ड करके आप रख सकते हो. ही हैड दिस चेयर स्पेसिफिकली फॉर हिम, और वो उस पे बैठते थे. बट सिंस आफ्टर ही पास्ड अवे, माय डैड यू नो स्टार्टेड यूजिंग इट बिकॉज़ इट वाज अ गुड चेयर, अच्छा कंडीशन वगैरह, मिडिल क्लास फैमिली, नया चेयर थोड़ी ना लेंगे. ये हो गया. सो वन नाइट व्हाट हैड हैपेंड कि पापा घर पे लेट आए, और ही ऐसा है कि इफ जो लास्ट अगर जागा रहता है, तो ही हैज टू क्लोज ऑल द डोर्स, सब पर्दे बंद करते, ही हैज टू चेक एवरीथिंग. So he's on, we have all slept. Papa jaage hai, he's sitting on that chair watching news, TV, whatever, movies dekh rahe hai. Then he felt dizzy, neend aa gayi aur aake so gaye. Now his version is he vividly remembers ki unhone kurchi fold ki thi aur rakh di thi aur sare parde band kar diye the. Abhi hall ka ek layout dete rehta hu ki parde band ho jane ke baad it's total dark except ki ek chota sa bhagwan ka wo mandir hai, matlab ghar घर पे होता है ना, तो उसका एक दिया जलता रहता है, तो सिर्फ उसका ही लाइट है, अदरवाइज इट्स पिच ब्लैक. ठीक है, ओके. तो वो आके सो गए. तो पता नहीं रात को फिर अचानक से ही गॉट अप, प्यास लग गया, व्हाटएवर. एंड ही सॉ, हॉल में आए, ही सॉ कि द चेयर ऐसे थोड़े वो लाइट में दिख रहा है कि द चेयर वो है वैसे ही. उसको खोल के ऐसा लग रहा है क्योंकि तो बैठा है, बिकॉज यू कैन हियर द बैठते हुए एक प्रेशर आता है हल्का सा नीचे फुट पे, foot of the chair when you sit thoda sa expand ho jata hai sort of. So he could feel ki there's somebody sitting, but he is not sure kyunki khali diye ka light gir raha hai, but the chair is not folded. Wo jahan pe wo baithe the wahi pe hai, jahan pe mostly dada baithte, nana baithte the. इट्स स्टिल देयर. तो उनके और वो थोड़े फट्टू टाइप भी है पापा, तो वो एक दो सेकंड के लिए फट गए उनकी, फ्रीज हो गए. लेकिन जैसे जैसे हिम्मत जुटा के फटाफट जाके लाइट चालू कर दिया, बट एज सून एज ही स्विच्ड ऑन द लाइट ही कुड फील दैट समबडी हैड गॉटन अप एंड जस्ट पास थ्रू हिम. ही कुड फील अ ब्रीज बट द विंडोज वर नॉट शट, बट पर्दा लगाया था तो अगर कुछ होता तो हवा वाहि नहीं आती. ओके, सो दिस वॉज द फर्स्ट इंसिडेंट. एंड ये बहुत टाइम से उन्हें नहीं बताया, बट बाद में बताया ऑब्वियसली. So this was the first incident. Can I move on to the second?
Yes, please, please. Yes. Now we are invested.
Okay, okay.
Season two.
Yeah. So second ye hua, now my nana and my nani were very close, like ek proper jo hota hai couple ka aur vagera. They were very close, but after he passed away, and it was an for us it was a very unexpected death. So nani ko to jo jhatka laga hoga wo shayad सोच भी नहीं सकते कि क्या होगा होगा. सो इवेंचुअली विद इन टू और थ्री इयर्स इवन नानी शी वाज डिटेक्टेड विद अल्जाइमर्स. शी स्टार्टेड फॉरगेटिंग अ लॉट ऑफ थिंग्स एंड शी वेंट बैक टू अ टाइम वेर हर डॉटर इज नॉट मैरिड, एज इन माय मॉम इज नॉट मैरिड एंड आई एम नॉट बॉर्न.
ओके.
So she always used to be like, like pointing at me, who am I? For me, I don't remember most of these things, but suddenly this hit me when I recently discussed it with my mom because of one incident which will come in the end, if you allow me.
Sure.
But I don't remember all of this because I was so young and we had just moved out here and I barely remember those time, but ye sab hua and I don't, but she remembers it vividly and it hurt her because this nani ne मुझे बड़ा किया है, वो मुझे भी पहचान ही नहीं है. ये
इट्स टफ. आई नो
दिस हैपेंड विद हर एंड देन शी इवेंचुअली या बोथ हर वन नाइट शी हैड अ गुड टाइम. वी वर वाचिंग सम एक बहुत पुरानी पिक्चर देख रहे थे, लेकिन अभी आई गेस इट वाज अमिताभ बच्चन मूवी. वो देख के रात तक जगे हुए थे सेट मैक्स से पहले आया कर. नॉट सूर्यवंशी जो भी है वो नहीं, अच्छी वाली थी कोई तो. But okay, that was a good time, and then she slept. But in the morning, like thodi time, like at dawn, she started like shouting and so, or she wouldn't wake up. Then she started try to wake her up, and hospital rushed kiya. There we found out ki both her kidneys were about to fail. Yeah. So it was on critical support. I ventilator par thi, but doctor said ki chance nahi hai. Ventilator se nikal diya, and she passed away in like 30 minutes or so. So this happened and we were all shell shocked. My mom was like, she couldn't stop crying for a lot of long time. Every time her topic came up, she just, this happened. ये होने के बाद after a few months school मतलब मैं school से थोड़ा late आया करता था क्योंकि cricket वगैरह खेलना होता था. तो घर पे सिर्फ मम्मी होती थी और नाना, वो नाना के भाई होते थे. Now the sad thing is कि अभी वो भी bedridden हो गए. She used to literally be alone, like let's say working in the kitchen, and this happened to her once. घर पे कोई नहीं है. नाना too is sort of sleeping, is bedridden. He's sleeping and my mom could feel like a hand on her shoulder. Like a proper hand.
Comforting.
Yes, and this the reference to this would be that when my mom was learning to cook from her nani, she always used to do this. Like kuch bhi agar samjhana hota tha to nani kandhe pe haath rakh ke samjhati thi mummy ko.
Right.
So this spooked her because this happened ek bar hua, do bar hua, ignore kar diya, but it happened like ek do mahine ke baad ye bahut bar hone lag gaya tha. So one day she just broke down crying and when I came home, and then she told me that this all happened, etc., etc. So this was the second incident. I'm really sorry if I'm taking much time.
No, Sanjeev.
Now, so we have to listen to the last part. नहीं तो कहीं सब मेरे को
बाहर ले रहे हैं. The third.
Okay.
The third. Hoezaay की जानबूझ के कर रहे हैं. हाँ.
Okay.
Please continue.
Third one. Okay. The third one, I remember it vividly because I actually witnessed this, and it was very jarring for me. तो अभी आई मीन अरे मुंबई में SYJC का कॉन्सेप्ट है ना, तो 11 12th ही हो जाता है वो बेसिकली फॉर ऑल द दिल्ली. तो 11 12th में था, तो आई यूज्ड टू कम होम थोड़ा ऐसा 4 बजे 5 बजे के आसपास. एंड हम लोग का घर थोड़ा ऐसा डुप्लेक्स टाइप है, तो मेरा स्टडी रूम ऊपर होता था, तो मैं जैसे कॉलेज से आता तो ऊपर चले जाता था, और नानू टू का रूम मेरे वो नीचे ही है, मतलब अगर कुछ होता था उनको तो मुझे डायरेक्ट बुला सकते थे. एंड इन थोड़ा बहुत बिकॉज ही बाय दिस टाइम ही कुडंट स्पीक, वी हैड गिवन हिम अ बेल सॉर्ट ऑफ,
ओके,
सो यू कैन रिंग इट.
या
सो आई हैड कम फ्रॉम कॉलेज वन डे, आई वेंट अ फ्रेश वॉश होके स्टडी रूम में चला गया नीचे, आई हर्ड समथिंग एज इफ कुछ तो गिर गया, ऐसा आवाज आई मुझे, बट आई डिड मुझे ऐसा रिकॉलेक्ट नहीं हो कि क्या गिर सकता है, आई मीन ऐसा कुछ है ही नहीं जो ऐसी आवाज कर सके, बट देन आई थॉट कि व्हाट इफ इट्स नानू, नानू टू, आई मीन नानू, व्हाट इफ इट्स नानू. तो मैं भाग के नीचे आया एंड ही वाज एक्चुअली, ही हैड एक्चुअली फॉलन डाउन फ्रॉम हिज बेड.
ओ मैन.
एंड ही कुडंट रिंग, ही वाज ट्राइंग टू रीच द बेल बट ही कुडंट रीच इट बिकॉज इट वाज ऑन द बेड.
ओके.
And he couldn't even get up. Unko, he had some spine ka thing. He couldn't, after a point of time, he couldn't stand up straight. So he had just fallen there and trying to reach the bell, but he couldn't. And when I tried to pick him up, I called my mom. My mom was in the other room. I called my mom. And I tried to pick him up and his legs swung in a way it shouldn't have.
Okay.
They had broken. The legs had broken. Like I say, pendulum jaise hill rahe. So we rushed him to the hospital. He couldn't sustain the injuries. It was too much for him. And eventually we brought him home. Because hospital mein rakhne ka kuch matlab nahi tha, ghar pe laya. And he passed away in a week's time or so.
Oh, wow. Sorry now, about that.
I told you this is going to be personal. I'm really sorry.
No, it's okay. It's okay.
No worries. Go ahead, man.
Now, after that, that room was sort of abandoned for a month or so.
Yeah.
It was his room and it was meant for him, all his clothes were there, everything.
Yeah.
That room was abandoned. So ek din hum log ne kya socha, Sunday tha, sab ghar pe the. Now it's just the three of us. Sab ghar pe the. So I was like, theek hai chalo saaf kar dete, agar kuch kapde honge to donate kar denge, ya it's of no use to us now. So I pura din saaf kiya, sab bed ye kiya wo kiya. तो रात को फिर मुझे लगा कि मेरे रूम में जाने से अच्छा मैं यही सो जाता हूँ, बेडशीट वगैरह सब तो चेंज तो कर ही दिया है, एंड आई वाज टू लेजी टू गो बैक टू माय रूम, यहाँ पे अच्छा है, एसी है सब, या गद्दी भी है, यही सो जाता हूँ. ये हो जाने के बाद आफ्टर दिस हैपेंड, ये फ्रेश फ्रेश होके आ गया, एसी चालू किया, सो गया और दरवाजा बंद किया है मैंने. नाउ द वे आई हैड एक्चुअली केप्ट द अलमारी जिस तरह से रखी थी मैंने, बेड अगर एंड द बेड वॉज इन सच अ वे दैट इफ आई लुक लेफ्ट, देयर इज अ अलमारी है और वहां पे मिरर है, और मिरर में डोर का रिफ्लेक्शन है विच इज ऑन द अदर साइड, सो आई यूजली स्लीप विद माई फेस डाउन. और जैसे अभी लॉकडाउन में ऐसा हो रहा है कि मतलब यू टायर योर सेल्फ टू स्लीप, एज इन बेड पे पड़ते ऐसा पूरा कोमा टोज रहे, डायरेक्ट सुबह उठते. And I'm a very heavy sleeper. मतलब कुछ भी हो जाए, yes, I won't wake up. Like it had happened कि earthquake हो गया तो फिर भी मैं नहीं उठा था, minor earthquake, whatever. So I slept पूरा चादर ये करके, and in the middle of the night, पता नहीं मुझे ऐसे I woke up. मतलब my eyes are open, but जैसे आप लोग बोलते हो कि sleep paralysis हो गया था. But my face is looking right directly at my reflection in the mirror.
Right.
And the door is open.
Okay. The door you had shut.
Yes.
Okay.
And thus I could see a silhouette. That is not standing upright. It's bent down, just like Nano 2. I'm looking right at it. बट आई कैनॉट, मुंह से कुछ निकल नहीं रहा है, ना ही मेरी बॉडी हिल रही है, सिर्फ आंखें बड़ी हो गई है. आई एम लुकिंग एट माई सेल्फ एंड आई एम लुकिंग एट द सिलुएट.
बाप रे, ओह माय गॉड, दैट्स सम हैवी स्टफ ब्रो. आई एम सो सॉरी फॉर ऑल द लॉसेस दैट योर फैमिली हैज गॉन थ्रू,
बट दे जस्ट टू शो दैट दे आर विद यू एंड दे आर लुकिंग आफ्टर यू, सो रियली डोंट हैव एनीथिंग टू वरी अबाउट.
या या, जस्ट आई विल जस्ट एंड दिस कि यार, ये होने जाने के बाद आई वोक अप इन द मॉर्निंग, द डोर वाज शट. But and I was in the same position, but I could not remember this. And thodi der ke baad I remembered it. I was like freaked out, and turant maine ja ke mummy ko bata diya tha.
Okay.
But this happened, and this actually dates back also to your question. Someone had asked ki what would you do if you saw your loved one as a ghost, or what if the ghost was a loved one?
Yeah, so, make a run it's a crazy, it's just so much of emotion and experience that you go through, right? It's so tough, man.
Sanjeet, first of all, thank you so much for sharing something this personal with us, man. Yeah. And
I hope it was scary. Because
it was spooky, man. Do you still live in the same home?
Yes.
You still there? Yeah. Okay, so calling us from there.
It's actually, ये सब होने के बाद फिर पापा ने भी अपना स्टोरी बताया, और फिर ये सब जब सामने आया तो हम लोगों ने सोचा कि एक गृह शांति जैसे बोलते हैं या सत्यनारायण जो होती है वो एक करवाई थी हम लोग ने, बट हाँ उसके बाद से तो नहीं हुआ था, बट वी स्टिल मॉम स्टिल बिलीव्स कि दे आर स्टिल विद अस, एटलीस्ट नानी इज स्टिल विद अस,
राइट? Yeah,
looking over us, all the good stuff.
You know, there's this one thing that they say, a lot of people have also told me, try to not sleep in front of a mirror, or don't have a mirror next to your bed which you can look at. I have friends who had like acute body pain, some other problems, because they say at night when your spirit travels also, it shouldn't catch itself in its reflection. Just see. I don't know. It's just something that people say. You don't have to believe it. But
it's really dropping some shivering stuff there.
No, it's true. Like, what? It is true.
Spirit in the mirror. No.
Yeah,
but mirror.
Read up on it. So they say that even some Chinese feng shui people say it. Other people also believe it, that you shouldn't have a mirror facing your bed or where you sleep.
Yeah, like your foot. Like at the foothold of the bed.
Thank you, Cyrus. Thank you so much, Sanjeet.
And Sanjeet, that was a beautiful story, bro.
Final formality.
Thanks a lot, man.
Cyrus, big fan.
Thank you so much, bro.
I've loved you since Hole in the Wall and Sab Khelo Sab Jeeto. I mean,
thank you so much, brother. Thank you.
Sir, aur ek main batana chahta hu, why, I don't know why everybody's simping on you in the chat, but they have never mentioned Mind the Malhotras.
Yeah, why? I don't think it's the demographic. Amazing. Yeah. We're shooting season 2 soon.
Sanjeet, look, wo train aage Panvel ki taraf gaya, wapas aa rahe abhi.
Acha, okay.
Please,
padega. Sir, same cheez. Everybody sims on you for Hera Feri. Aapka it was a good. Aapka role kafi acha tha. The hair movements were not so flattery, but fine. But sir, aap dil to pagal hai mein the, sir.
अरे बाप रे,
थैंक यू संजीत, एंड प्लीज गिव योर पेरेंट्स अ बिग हग फ्रॉम ऑल ऑफ अस.
ओके फॉर संजीत टू गो, अभी मेरे बारे में ठीक है.
आई मीन संजीत, यू वांट टू से समथिंग अबाउट होजे, देन मेबी
कुछ भी बोल सकते
हैं. तेरी मां का
सुख, अगर आप देख रहे तो संजीत की बातें सुनिए.
संजीत, थैंक्स सो मच फॉर कॉलिंग अस बड़ी, थैंक्स फॉर शेयरिंग, हैव अ गुड वन.
थैंक यू सो मच,
टेक केयर,
गुड नाइट. Thank you so much.
Hey, बड़े हरामी हो तुम लोग, बड़े हरामी हो. When he's praising you all, करो.
I hope Uncle was still watching.
Yeah. Cyrus, I want to ask you about this mirror thing. You said about the whole mirror at the footstep, but can you explain the fact that you have a mirror on top of your bed?
That's some stuff. So the thing is, if you have a mirror on top of your bed, then your spirit leaves and just doesn't return. That's why a lot of people in Bombay, especially if you see, are soulless.
I know why Cyrus has a big mirror on top over there. See, many people are having bad thoughts and all, but the truth is, when you look into the mirror, you can see the reflection, right? So he holds his TV backwards like that.
That's right. That's exactly what I have it. That's right. And I have a rotating bed.
Oh, nice. So that's beautiful.
Guys, this is it. This is the final.
Brother, it's
call.
12 o'clock again, Jose.
This is your fault for say for bro, lying such long
story.
This stories.
Is the last story. Like one. This is such a beautiful story, man. This was a
look,
beautiful
but story. Every story has a different kind of flavor, and some of it is very scary, some of it is personal. Every story has its place. Tum log skip karo, find that guy who does the timestamps.
You know, Jose, this story was very interesting. Like the family that moves into this house, it's a 6-bedroom house. Little by little, things happen to the family. It's like a series, man.
Yeah. Okay. Before we go into our last story, please do not forget to hit that like button. It really helps. It pushes our stream up. If you have already liked it, unlike, re-like. If you're not enjoying and you want to go to Panvel, hit dislike. Not a problem. Leave a comment. It'll help. Pritish, बहुत pressure है आपके ऊपर. You are the last.
Pritish, what is this?
Shouting
at
you.
पोथड़े खुल जाने चाहिए हमारे.
Pritish looks like a guy who shouts. I feel like.
Yeah, capital में कितनी बार लिखा उसने.
तेरा keyboard का caps stuck है.
See how sweet he is. क्या बात कर रहे हो सुरेश? क्यों हो जाए?
I'm very worried about
really one. I hope he's just messing with you, man.
Pritish, I think based on his background.
Sorry.
तुम्हारे भूत को मिलता है चार पॉइंट बेटा.
सिरिल को मैं पकड़ के मारेगा. सिरिल यू टेल हिम टू स्टार्ट द स्टोरी. तो
अच्छा प्रीतिश क्या हो रहा है तेरे भूत का कहानी पे.
So this happened with my client. Okay, so I'm a lawyer, and this happened to my client's friend. The guy, let's call him, I don't know, Rahul.
Okay. Rahul.
Yeah. Okay. Suresh Rahul. Also.
Let's call him Suresh.
Okay, let's call him. This guy lost his parents under really mysterious circumstances. He had stepped out to, you know, get some groceries. He came home and found his parents dead. And, you know, doctors, it was some cardiac arrest. It was pretty weird.
Damn.
At the age of 27, he got married to his school friend. And everything was okay. Until I think he turned 34. Now, some random day, he came home from work. And it was quite late. It was 11:30, 12. He noticed that his wife, let's call her, I don't know, Seema, maybe.
Cyrus.
Hey, let me be. Please keep it in the realism.
Yeah. Mark? Bro, okay. I'm getting out of the story. Yeah.
Okay. So, Seema, yes.
All right, Seema. So, Seema had finished dinner. And she just said, you know what, the food is kept in the fridge. Why don't you just have it? He says, okay. He had his food. He went to bed. Around 2 o'clock, he got up and he found that his wife was not there. So he heard some voice from the living room. He went to the living room. He noticed his wife. Hello?
Yeah. He's writing this down.
He noticed his wife. She was sitting near the window. She was looking outside the window as if, you know, she was looking at somebody. And she had this huge bowl of rice with her.
Okay.
And she was just making tiny balls of rice and she was eating that rice. Now this guy obviously, I mean, he freaked out. He just asked her, what's wrong with you? What's happening? She just, you know, turned to her and he looked at her. She looked at him. She just smiled and just went to bed. And this guy obviously shitting bricks. She went to bed. He couldn't sleep all night, obviously, but she just didn't say anything. She just went to sleep. The very next day, again, the same thing happened. But this time he came home at 8 o'clock, 8 p.m. They had dinner together. And, you know, they went to sleep. Again at 2 o'clock, he found his wife was missing. He heard some noise from the living room. Now this time his wife was again sitting near the window, looking outside the window with a bowl of, now apparently this was raw chicken.
What?
Yeah.
This is the next day.
Yeah, the next day, yes. So this was apparently some raw chicken and she was shocked because she was vegetarian. Right? So this was quite disturbing for him. So he again, you know, approached her and, you know, pucha usse, what's wrong with you? Are you okay? Do you need help? We just go to the doctor. What's wrong with you? She again just looked at him, smiled, and went to bed. This guy couldn't go to his bedroom. He just sat outside the whole night. The very next day, he was thinking, you know, I think I shouldn't go home because he was so goddamn scared.
Fair enough, bro.
So, anyways, he
in this home during the course of this, no conversation with the wife in the middle.
Nothing. She didn't even recollect anything that happened.
Okay.
So the third day, everything was normal. They finished their dinner, and now this time he planned to stay awake the entire night. He wanted to see what happens. So he was just lying on the bed. His wife was sleeping next to him, I don't know. I think around 2 o'clock, I think he fell asleep. But now this time he woke up. And he noticed as he realized that somebody is, you know, sniffing him. And he woke up and he noticed his wife was standing next to him and she was sniffing him. This guy jumped out of the bed, went to some corner of their room, and he started yelling at her, "What is wrong with you?" Because this time his wife had a knife in her hand. And he yelled, "What's wrong with you? What is happening? Just tell me, I'm here to help."
she just said, you know what, I really want to live forever. And I really need your flesh for it. I'm performing some ritual and I need a human flesh. I need a flesh of a man who I really, really, truly love. And I really need your flesh. And the condition was the guy's, the person whose flesh she was planning to eat, that person should not have parents. And the person's parents should have died like 10 years ago. Basically, the date of the death of the parents should be, there should be a gap of 10 years.
A decade.
A decade. And I really liked you in school. So I had to take care of your parents. He's like, what the fuck do you mean?
Oh. What? 1 minute.
So
what
she planned it. She planned it from.
I really liked you in school. So what? So I had to take care of your parents.
Yeah. So he's like, what the fuck do you mean? It was a cardiac arrest. So she said, why don't you just look under your bed? And he looked under the bed. And there were two dolls, a needle right and through their chest. This guy obviously shat bricks. Got out of his house, started running on the street, started calling for help. Now my client told me, this guy committed suicide. He died by suicide. He just ran and just, I don't know, some train ke samne aake just died. Now, apparently people say that he was actually planning to go to the cops because of his wife. And then wife just manipulated and she just, you know, उसको फोर्स किया कि तू जाके ट्रेन के सामने आ एंड दैट इज हाउ इट
वाओ ब्रो थैंक्स फॉर शेयरिंग दैट
बट देन हाउ डज एनीबॉडी नो दिस स्टोरी देन
सो आई थिंक दैट गर्ल हु डिड ऑल दिस आई थिंक शी वाज क्वाइट नोन फॉर सच वियर्ड थिंग्स द ओनली डिफरेंस इज दैट दिस गाय हु शी वाज मैरिड टू डिड नॉट नोटिस थिंग्स
बट
knew this
red flags motherfucker
but Pritesh, what about client confidentiality and all
well even for
I'll just harassing you
secondly client's friend so it was not really my
Yeah. So hold
friend,
on a second.
Friend,
so,
friend,
so,
in the
so hold on a second. Let me get this right. This guy starts running and then he gets hit by a train or something. And
yeah, he apparently ran to a train. Cyrus, right? You don't want to go home?
Okay, man. Fucking hell, bro. What the fuck kind of story
is this? No. So let Cyrus, please answer.
Go. Ask the questions. I'll let you do.
And he died.
Then how do you know the story? How do we know what happened between that husband and that wife in the room?
This is the confidentiality. No, this is what people are assuming has happened through putting pieces together.
Yeah.
Please, it's a ghost story stream. This is not the Sherlock Holmes.
But ke pothade khul gaye mere. That's unnerving. And where is she now? Jose, just look.
Which area was this?
I'm not going in a geographical fucking continent.
So Suresh is making a map so we can avoid all these places.
Yeah. Pritesh, where is this place that it happened? The story?
Somewhere in Dadar. I'm not sure.
Dadar?
You know, can I tell you the married part about them, you know, having dinner and then going to sleep and then not speaking the whole day, then having dinner and then going to sleep, not speaking the whole day.
That's the part you didn't believe, yeah.
That's the part I believe because married people are like, oh, that's kind of normal. That's okay, that happens.
That's a healthy marriage, bro.
That's a healthy marriage. Anyway, yeah. Pritesh, thanks for chatting with us.
That
thanks for sharing,
freaky,
buddy.
Bro. Thank you so much. Pritesh, tell me something. What if you get a letter tomorrow saying you shouldn't have said that?
Just burn it with salt or something. Put it in front of a mirror. Because otherwise you can give him some ideas on how to deal with that.
That is so freaky. If a couple on their honeymoon or they're just dating and they start watching this stream,
they'll be looking at each other.
This guy is gonna be like,
but bro, can I tell you this kind of stuff? Like the first time I met my wife, okay.
Wow.
Not the first time, sorry.
I'm hoping she doesn't watch your shit.
Let me she knows the story. She knows the story.
Okay. You want to tell it? Okay, you tell. Okay.
So, the first time we spent the night together in my mom's place, okay. Hopefully my mom won't watch this or whatever. But I remember my mom was cleaning the house and she was she had removed all the curtains and stuff.
Oh.
No, she removed the curtains. So there was moonlight coming out from there. And I didn't know my wife that well. We were sort of dating, knew each other. This was the first time we'd spend the night together. And this was my mom's place. And the moonlight was like directly on her face. And I kept thinking, what if this woman is insane? And I mean, years later, I found out that's true. But then...
That is so freaky. I had the same situation. I had the same situation with my girlfriend, and we were sleeping, and I was having a bad dream. I don't know what, something was happening to me, and she tried to wake me up. And she has really long hair, and her hair was over her face. And I woke up from the dream, and her face was here.
Oh my god!
She said I jumped out of my bed and over her head and towards this corner, and I was screaming.
Oh my god.
And we just started like hanging out, and
then your girlfriend starts punching you. Stop it.
You know, but Suresh.
Oh, she started crying and screaming also.
What Hoezaay left out in the story was his wife his then girlfriend turns to him and says, look below the bed. And then Hoezaay looked below the bed, and there were two dolls. And then he's like, oh, there are my dollies. I forgot where I kept them.
Very funny.
It didn't go too well for the relationship after that, but they came about.
But you know,
can I end this? There were two dolls. And then Hoezaay pulled out the doll and gently started scratching one leg. And 250 miles north of the compass, scratching. Suresh Menon screamed in his bed saying, oh God,
who's touching
not
my
again.
Leg?
Not again.
Bro, when that girl was telling us a story about seeing Batman in the beach in Alibag.
Yeah.
And
she didn't say Batman.
That was our interpretation of it. I remember when I was working at MTV, we were shooting for the show where we would all go around in Tata Nanos and live in the car. Okay.
Wow, so she really didn't work out.
The contestants were living in the car. And one night, they planned the thing, like, you know, it's a reality show or whatever, so they planned where we were going, and there was a kind of like a jungle next to the beach. So this one guy who was the expert, and they had hired him for the show, he was the expert, and he said come, and there's a big group, yeah, like must have been 15 of us, you know, sound, camera, contestants, then producer, director, right. Everyone walking, and really late night, pitch black. And Orissa's beaches are amazing, like beautiful. Okay.
Yeah. Beautiful.
But somehow no breeze from any side. Anyway, so we've gone into this kind of like mangrove area. It's completely pitch dark. So in this moment, now that expert says to us, he said, guys, don't worry. I'm an expert. I've done this many, many times. He started talking like Cyrus for some reason. He said, I've done this many, many times. And don't worry. You see that tree over there? You see the red marking on it? We just have to follow all the trees with the red marking. So we're walking. Literally 2 minutes later, he says, wait a second. Can anybody find any trees with red marks over it? We were like, what the fuck, bro? Really? So imagine. But anyway, he finally got his bearings. This is not a ghost story. This is just something that happened to us. He finally got his bearings and we got out. But imagine if something like that happened and we all started getting taken away by Batman.
Oh yeah. Yeah. Like have any of you seen an entity like this?
I saw a little boy curled up over a grave in Mussoorie with my friends Samir and Arjun Kakkar.
But why was he curled up with Samir?
Why was Samir
on the grave? On the grave.
That was, I should have asked that. Yeah.
Bloody comedians. Yeah.
Yeah. Right. I've seen that, by the way. I've seen an entity. If you ever been to a beach called Aksa.
Aksa, of course.
You've seen.
I've seen something in Aksa.
Okay, please calm down. We'll do all these chats.
Okay.
We'll chat about this post stream, guys.
I don't know. It's 12
o'clock, guys. I'm going to black out.
I like to go to sleep. I'm tired.
I don't want to talk about anything.
I slept in between a couple of times. But
yeah, we know. People notice that Cyrus is going to sleep.
I blacked out.
How are you guys sleeping with your eyes open? Anyway, guys, thanks so much for being on the stream. 3,000 plus people. I hope you had fun with all these crazy ups and downs and mad stories. Harami Chat was in the house saying all kinds of hardcore things. I wanted to read some of those. It's so funny.
Dude. But it's really on ball today.
Watching this, the stream's second rewatch of the stream with the chat is another experience altogether. I want to say a big thank you to all our amazing paranormal experts, Cyrus Sahukar, Cyril Dabrio.
Shimi Shankar.
Suresh Menon, also known as Rod Stewart in this timeline.
And
Hoezaay Kovaco.
Thank you, everyone.
No filter
Thank
on
you.
Right now.
Good night. Don't forget to do that. Click, 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 like, and like. Have a good night.
It's 12.